Bonjour à tous. Et bienvenue pour un nouvel épisode de NBA 2K20. On continue notre ascension. Et ben on va compter en même temps. Il nous reste 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23. 22 matchs. 22 matchs avant les playoffs. Donc, bon, on va se mettre en route. Pardon.
You spent so much time in 2K20 creating builds. What is one thing you'd like to see with the build system or the archetype system going into
Et
next year?
I kind of would like to see a little bit more of a, I don't know how to say it, kind of more like of a balance. This year, the popular build is blue, and I think it's blue and green, you know, finishing and shooting. But then you're kind of really limited to only
Bah oui,
shooting,
la
you can't really
défense.
dribble too much.
La défense. Et donc, ouais, on va se mettre, on se met en route tout doucement. Notre but, c'est clairement de gagner, en fait. Un maximum de matchs pour essayer de rester dans le top 5. Et puis, je vous le cache pas, hein, franchement, il y a de grandes chances que je participe au playoff. Je dis bien qu'il y a de grandes chances, mais je sais pas si on va gagner. Hein, c'est tendu, mais on verra bien. Pour l'instant, on a 20 matchs à faire. Faisons les 20 matchs.
Mitchell is the two with Ingles at the three. Gobert is out there with Bogdanovich, and it's Conley in at the one. And for Boston, Hayward at small forward with Tatum at the four. Shea is out there with Brown, and it's Tice in at the five, patrolling the paint.
Bon,
two teams, Steve, from
ça commence déjà super bien. Hein.
No shortage of history between them.
Yeah, it's still a rivalry. I know they don't play a lot. These two teams. They simply, Kevin, they don't like each other, so this should be a good one.
Now, here's Nash.
Oh, il est joli.
It's good. He makes his first shot of the game.
Staying open to what develops.
Il est joli, on se prend un 2, il met un 3. En plus, il le green.
Conley feeling it out. Outside Bogdanovich. And the officials calling for a 3-second violation. And he has been on another level this past month, getting Eastern Conference Player of the Month, Shea.
He's really been on his A game lately. You know, the way their offense is set up, it really relies on his ability. He sets the tone each time down the floor, and he's been a lot of fun to watch.
Foot.
With the way that he's played and the way the front office has talked about, Greg, it's clear
Allez.
That the team views Shea as a building block for the future.
I'm not sure anyone would have predicted that at the beginning of his career, Kevin, but Shea has been an absolute boon for this team. Not a surprise that the front office sees him as a long-term piece of the puzzle.
Now here's Gobert. 14 points from him the last game against New York.
He was really aggressive on the glass, too. He really racked up on the boards out there.
And once he gets clear off the screen, there is no stopping him.
No, not when there's a flush waiting to happen.
That's a big-time move and a big-time finish.
Conley against Nash. Pass to Hayward. Six to shoot. Back to Jay. Stolen by Michael Conley. You know, here we go. Conley, no.
C'est de ma faute. J'ai demandé la balle en fait.
Mike Conley is incredible in transition, using his ridiculous speed to beat everyone down the court.
The pass to Hayward.
Dommage.
Wow, that's one you just kind of assume is going in. Tough luck.
From outside the arc, and it's Conley that time on the assist.
Joli. il met un 3. J'étais pas dessus. Ah, dommage.
Still can't believe that one didn't fall.
This offense has really been clicking.
And they know it, guys. They're playing right now with the kind of energy that is hard to deal with. The ball movement on this run has been fantastic and is a big part of why they've been able to get these good looks. And you think back to the beginning of the season when Che had trouble finding minutes. Not the case anymore, as he is a big part of this team. What a difference a season can make.
I think it's almost like he's a completely different player, Greg, than he was at the start of the season. Just great improvement. We've both seen it across the board. Here's Mitchell after Gordon Hayward's bucket. Mitchell's shot is good. He has 6.
Just look at the way Mitchell's built. The strength in the upper body.
Just over 3 minutes gone here in the first.
On se reprend. J'ai failli faire un retour en zone.
Back to Nash. Gobert with the block. Hayward against Engel. On the wing, Mitchell. Pass to Conley. That one misses. So the Celtics will take it the other way. Hayward against Engel. Cash outside.
Dommage.
Rebound by Mitchell. Utah comes into this one after the win against New York.
Oh là là.
Conley gets the bucket.
I like the efficiency here.
Ça m'aurait fait plaisir de le mettre, mais bon.
So the Celtics call timeout. They're first.
Allez.
You know, he stands 6'3.
Putain, j'appuie, ça veut pas passer, ça me dégoûte.
6'11 wingspan, more than compensates. He has the tools to be an elite two-way player.
And checking out some numbers. Ah, il a même pas vu si je devais faire l'entraînement ou quoi.
Since the All-Star break going really to another level. First in rebounding.
Ah purée, mon bonhomme est déjà froid quoi.
Top 10 in field goal percentage, really able to power his way to the bucket and finish through contact.
And just going back real quick to the fact that he's tops in the league in rebounds.
Eh oui, je fais une faute pour que tout le monde puisse revenir.
Here's Mitchell, fouled on the shot and picks up 2 points, so one free throw coming up. And look at the physical profile for Mitchell.
Putain, on est en premier carton, les mecs ont déjà leur takeover.
Doesn't shrink from the big moments, he embraces that spotlight.
Jay outside.
Oh là là.
6 on the shot clock. Back to Che. Trains the three-pointer.
Well-designed play. Che catching in rhythm and delivering.
Jazz leading by 8. Mitchell passes to Gobert. Back to Mitchell. Pass to Bogdanović. Tatum. Bogdanović, no luck.
Great focus on the defensive end there to contest that shot.
And this is where you would prefer to work the ball to someone else for just a better
bien. Bien, Tatum.
Has lived up to lofty expectations. Tatum impacts the game across the board.
And stolen by Nash. To the inside.
Oh là là, mais j'ai... Je fais n'importe quoi, le mec il avance même pas quoi. Putain. On récupère la balle, la contre-attaque est pourrie. Je le sais, il faut plus que je fasse ce coup-là. J'avais dit que je le ferais plus. Et maintenant c'est clair.
Gobert's got his 4th rebound in this one and stolen by Nash. Tatum on the wing.
Oh putain, dommage.
Gobert's got rebound number 5 here tonight. It's stolen by Brown. Now the fast break. Tatum with the ball. Basket good. Tatum's got his second bucket of the night.
How about the speed with which Tatum gets down the court? Awesome at reading the defense and then exploiting the opportunity in the open floor.
Now here's Mitchell. He's coming off a 19-point game against New York. Back to Conley.
Ah putain, je l'ai vu partir.
That's their third straight make off an assist.
There's the pass to Tice.
Ah bah oui, tu l'avais vu.
And there's no excuse for allowing Brown to get that deep. He's just brilliant at jamming it down the defense's throat.
And a first time out of the game called for Utah.
And Smitty, as tough as they are on D, the Jazz have been middle of the pack offensively. How do they improve there? You know, GA, they could.
Comment ça va?
The two things that held them back are turnovers and poor free throw shooting.
Ah, ils m'ont déjà sorti. Allez. Ah non, mais là je joue très mal. Oh, c'est joli. Oh, comment ça se fait qu'on est chez nous et on récupère jamais nos rebonds, les gars? Putain, abusez pas. Voilà, il l'a mis, c'est bien ça. Allez. Allez, allez, monsieur l'arbitre, tenez le ballon. Vas-y, shoot. Joli.
Excellent, David, thank you. Greg, how impressive was it watching him completely take over?
Unstoppable. They won that game because of his effort and just his overall relentlessness.
That's what every player has control of, his level of activity.
Ah oui, oui, c'est le deuxième carton, ils ont...
Even if the shot isn't falling.
Here's Tatum. Michael Conley making his last shot.
Eh ben voilà, ça se réveille.
That's now 8 points for Jason Tatum.
Ça se réveille.
He just has a feel and a belief in what he's doing out there.
Attention les gars, attention. Les fautes aussi les gars, faites attention aux fautes. Ouh.
You know, I think always getting a chance, Kevin, to play minutes is best for a younger guy. But if it's hurting the teams, you don't want to see the coaching staff playing these younger guys just to get the one guy ready. I think you still have to think about the team. You have to have guys earn minutes for their rookie.
Putain, faut qu'ils arrêtent à chaque fois.
I think that's better for young teams.
And I like the fact
that chaque fois je veux mettre un panier, ils me font des fautes.
The Celtics have been good at the line so far, 5 of 5.
Enfin, ils me mettent des bâches. Après, la faute, c'est le petit plus, on va dire.
Everyone knows Chase is a passionate individual, but when the locker room gets tense, he comes with jokes to keep everyone loose.
Mais bon, quand on est petit, hein. Allez, ça c'est à moi. Et boum.
Chase got 7 points in the game.
Not easy to take that kind of contact and still deliver. Jay is tough.
And stolen.
Bah, dis donc.
Down low, Wanamaker.
Oh non, c'est pas possible. Peut-être un alley oop.
And bottom line, they found ways to score. Credit the game plan going in.
Peut-être le alley oop, je sais pas.
They knew that the arena would be rocking. They could execute well on the offensive end. They knew they could quiet down this hostile crowd.
But they get it back. Here's Gobert, and it's blocked.
Oh, c'est joli ça.
Inside.
Oh non, mais il vient pas. Il fout ma gueule lui. Et puis voilà, c'est ça un alley-oop. Regardez comment ça marche.
Trust your receiver to go get that pass.
Oh bordel.
Catch and finish in the same motion.
Now that's Nash. He's got seven. To the middle. From 11 feet away. No good on the shot.
Déjà tu... Oh là là... C'est pas possible... Bah ouais, je l'ai pas couvert. C'est pas possible... Oh là là...
And this is why you gave Hayward big money, not just a score in this offense.
Je pense que quand je dois claquer un alley-oop, je le fais pas, et quand je dois pas, je le fais. Ah non, j'étais là. Déçu, grave déçu. J'aurais pu mettre un rebond dessus. Jason, voilà, bien Jason. Voilà, on s'est vu, on s'est vu, la machine est relancée. Dommage, dommage les gars, dommage, j'ai cru que voilà, j'ai cru que ça allait récupérer là.
You know, it's tougher to get recognition in a small market like Utah, Smitty. Rudy Gobert says he has to do three times as much to draw attention.
Ah, les fautes, là, mais c'est pas possible. M'arrache le bras, là, monsieur l'arbitre. Oh là là, il m'a... Injouable, injouable. Agression sur agression.
And both free throws good for Jay.
After having no trips to the free throw line in the first period, he's being much more aggressive now.
Poked away. And Gobert kicks to Conley. And the foul called on Jay. That's foul number two for him.
Ah là là, pourquoi quand je lui dis de faire mettre la main là, il la met au niveau du visage. Je lui dis pas, mais une claque dans sa gueule. Je lui dis. Je lui dis, voilà, mets la main. J'ai même pas fait gaffe, il me l'a donné comme ça, comme un gros sale. Ah oui, c'est mon bonhomme. Dessus les gars, dessus. Voilà. Voilà, on a nos, enfin, on a nos rebonds. Qu'est-ce que tu me fais des passes en arrière, toi?
And just not able to find the target from three-point range here in the second quarter, although he did knock down one in the first. Hard to figure out how he doesn't knock that one down. No defender in sight.
Pass to Tice.
C'est pas lui que je voulais donner, mais c'est pas grave. Allez, on dérange. Bon, ça fait des fautes, mais bon.
Keeps his concentration on the basket. It is impressive. Even when he's getting fouled, he stays with the play.
Brown is checked in for 3 minutes. Ouais.
Last season, Mike Conley became the Grizzlies' all-time leader in points scored. He was already first in assists, steals, and three-pointers.
Fait chier.
A
Ouais, je l'ai vu, mais je sais pas, il m'a tourné le dos, ça s'est mal goupillé.
Time 14 points for him. Back to Nash. That's in for his.
Voilà, le mouvement, le mouvement.
And Smitty, when it's all said and done, Mike Conley's jersey has to go in the Memphis Rams.
Absolutely, over a decade in a Grizzlies uniform, he helped lead them to the best years in franchise.
Ah là là. Ah, il me l'a mise. Elle est belle. J'ai cru qu'il allait tirer tout de suite, mais non. Avec la planche.
Mitchell passes to Gobert.
Oh, l'enfoiré, la passe. Elle était belle.
Mike Conley does an exceptional job of leading this team.
Ah, je l'ai pas mis. Trop de gênance.
Mitchell passes to Gobert. And slam dunk by Gobert. And that's a double-double for him now. 11 points.
Ah, t'es parti tout seul. Voilà. C'est bon ça, la défense était parvenue. Ça c'était, là c'était un peu abusé, hein. Je suis désolé mais. Voilà, ça c'est bien ça. Ça c'est mon gars sûr ça. Non! Mets-le! T'as pas le droit de louper ça! Oh là là!
With this lead, they're playing confidently, showing a quick trigger from beyond.
To the middle. Tice kicks to Tatum. Hayward on the wing, Ingles covering. Hayward can't hit. They can go two for one.
It's about being smart.
Au moins son rebond.
Mitchell against Brown. Now the pass to Ingles for three. Rebound Boston. Shot clock and game clock separated by less than 6 seconds.
Allez, donne. Voilà.
Nash has got it all tied up now for the Celtics.
Heat check after heat check. Che continues to show that this is his night.
Brown against Mitchell.
Ça joue tant, ça joue tant. Ça va, 59-59
à la mi-temps. And if you're just joining us, we've played through the first half in a game that's been fairly even so far. While you look at Shea in this game, he has been everywhere.
And he's shown just how adept he can be at creating contact and then cashing in at the line.
It's a part of his game that he can always tap into. There's an art to it,
hey.
And he is painting the canvas tonight.
All fueled up and ready to go. Let's reset the lineups courtesy of Gatorade for the second half of basketball. On the court for the Celtics, Brown and Hayward, they're the wing. Daniel Tice out there with Jason Tatum. And it's Jay in at the one spot. Hayward can't hit.
And gotta like what they've been doing down low in the post.
Down low, here's Bogdanović. And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here. Smitty, you've seen this before, separating teams that can make the deep playoff run, those that can't, that bounced out early. What have you found is the difference between those two?
Well, a lot of times, Kevin, it comes down to those teams have more talent that can make those deep playoff runs. Also, they can make adjustments. And then I think also they're a team that has better chemistry and they can win defensively and not just have to rely on their
own. Et voilà, comme ça, ça se passe le petit trou, je rentre. The Penetrator. C'est comme ça que je devrais me. Ça devrait être mon surnom au lieu de Tché. Allez les gars. Oh, t'as vu le trou? Avec la faute.
Beautiful location on the pass as usual. Led his man perfectly.
Et boum, le end one.
Here's Conley. 19 points in the game. Just over a minute and a half have passed here in the third quarter. And the foul called on Shane.
Ah, j'ai fait une faute. Oh, dans sa gueule. J'ai mis une claque dans sa gueule. Non, faut pas lui mettre des claques dans la gueule, je te l'ai déjà dit. Vise les mains, pas vise le visage. Ah non! Putain, mon bonhomme, je sais pas c'est quoi le bouton pour plonger.
A great distributor and decision maker among the top 10 in assists per game.
And as you said, number one in steals this season. He's the sneakiest ball hawk in the
league. Oh, le trou!
Hide everything you've got as he's coming after you. And there it is for him.
They should continue to get the ball inside. The defense struggling to contain them.
Conley, the pass to Gobert.
Ça, ce qui est chiant, c'est que j'ai toujours des trous pour faire des passes et pour qu'il me fasse des passes, mais je peux pas faire mes passes décisives et ça c'est chiant.
Tatum deciding where to go with it. Round the pass to Chain. And yes, it's good. Nash has got 28.
Et ça fait que je vais peut-être pas pouvoir faire mon double-double. Ou alors mon 20-10. Est-ce que je dois faire 20-10 en fait? Ah vas-y, t'es tout seul là. Ah je suis obligé, il y a un trou, je suis obligé de rentrer. Ah merde. J'ai rien fait. Pardon.
Ingles passes to Mitchell. No luck that time on the shot that would have put them on top. Pass to Chain. Lets it go from deep.
Ah, dommage.
And he didn't punish them for the weak coverage there, but they
can't him to continue missing.
Inside.
Ah, joli.
This is the shot you want right at the rim. Just couldn't deliver.
Oh non! J'ai fait un aller-oop, il n'y avait personne. Il a donné la balle à n'importe qui. Ah non, putain, 3 points. Ah putain.
The silent assassin Ingles continues to do his job and does it at a high level.
Mais lâchez-moi.
Again the miss by the Celtics. Jazz have gone 5 of 9 on field goal attempts since halftime.
Well, if you ask Rudy Gobert, he's not focused on his individual matchup. His job is to anchor the entire defense. For him, it is a team game.
Conley with it. He's got 23. And there's the pass to Mitchell. Conley against Nash. Floats one. Conley gets the bucket. Conley's got 6 points.
Je sais pas ce qui s'est passé. J'ai pas osé mettre la main. Allez. Oh, t'es bon toi. Oh non. Ils viennent me baiser une passe décisive. Si c'est pas abusé. Ah, il a allumé son takeover. Green's checked in. Jazz also changing it up. Bradley's checked in for Bogdanovich. Clarkson comes in for Joe Ingles. And Emmanuel Mudiay subbed in for Mike Conley. And a lot of contact on that one, so he'll shoot two here. You know, Smitty, every team at some point faces some locker room turmoil. How tough is it to balance team chemistry?
You know, it's very tough. Sometimes you have those one or two player additions. That it just changes the dynamic.
Je sais pas c'est quoi son takeover, je crois que c'est de la défense, non? Ah, c'est de la défense. Eh ouais, j'ai vu le trou. Passe dans le dos. Ah, dommage. Dommage, dommage.
Job of stepping up to the plate there, seizing back the momentum for his team.
That's the competitor in him. Close game. Let me have this one.
Oh non! Non, j'ai fait un double pas Green et il me bâche. Putain, je suis dégoûté. Putain, c'est la deuxième fois qu'on me le fait, ça. Jadis, ça m'était déjà arrivé. J'arrive tranquille, je green et le mec il me bâche. Il y a pas quand il y a green, c'est que c'est sûr que je le mets, il y a pas il y a plus le goal standing ou je sais plus trop quoi là, je sais que ça m'arrivait souvent dans NBA Jam à l'époque. Quand il y avait un shoot descendant ou je sais pas trop quoi, tu savais qu'il allait rentrer mais
on Jaylen Brown.
And you know, Clarkson entering the league as a second round pick, a little unsung for most of his career, but always seems to find a way to contribute.
Unfortunate that he missed one, but he still hit a crucial point there to help get his team the lead.
Hayward outside. Nash against Mitchell. Right side, Williams.
Good. Ah, joli.
Jay picking up the assist. Williams has got his second basket of the night.
You know, when Williams gets positioned inside, he just looks to dominate.
Ouais, j'ai le rebond. Ça compte. Enfin, je crois.
And so it's Jay making things happen for Boston. And his big game just keeps getting bigger. That...
Allez.
And meanwhile, coach Brad
quatrième carton.
Terrific game it's been so far with this fourth quarter sure to bring more pressure-packed basketball. And so in the game for the Jazz, Conley and Mitchell, the talented backcourt pair. Bogdanovich out there with Bradley. And it's Niang in at the small forward
Jolie
position. And the three ball is good. And it's 9 points for Gordon Hayward.
Not the guy you want to let catch fire. Hayward better be first on your mind.
Conley kicks to Mitchell. Down low, Bradley, and right on through for another basket. He's got 5 made on 5 of 9.
Eh ouais les gars, faut faire gaffe aussi derrière vous.
Taking big shots for you in big moments. That one was as easy as it.
Ah putain, ils sont deux contre moi. Là-bas. Ah non.
That was excellent contest.
Ça dégoûte.
From making something that's usually automatic.
Against Conley. Back to Bradley. Good. Nice job.
Ça dégoûte. Et de toute façon, ils vont être à deux contre moi, donc. Ah non! C'est quoi cette passe de merde? Ah non! Putain, je suis déçu. Joli.
Brown's got his sixth assist on the night. Now this is more like a 9 points form from 3 point range. This had that's 9 more than he had in the first.
Conley finds Bradley, slides through for his 7th basket in 11 tries. And guys, here in the fourth quarter, still a close game.
Instant classic, fellas. This one could come right down to the last shot.
And they double up Jay and finished off by Williams.
Bam! Passe décisive. S'il continue à faire ça, je vais les faire mes 10 passes décisives. Ah, la minute t-shirt.
Ça
devait être cool d'aller voir un match aux États-Unis comme ça pour voir pour voir le match déjà, puis surtout pour voir la minute t-shirt.
Here's what Boston's going with right now. Daniel Tice comes in for Robert Williams. And it's Jason Tatum.
Oh là là, c'est joli. C'est tellement magnifique quand ça marche comme tu prévois.
And it was great execution, clutch effort all the way around.
Now Conley. Rebound by the Celtics. Oklahoma City Thunder will be in town for the next one. And that game is the second of two straight at home. 2 points, that one goes.
What a turnaround for him.
J'ai appuyé une fois de plus, en fait, une fois de trop, c'est pour ça qu'il a... C'est moi qui fais la faute. Ouais, c'est moi. Putain, c'est con, je touche le ballon.
On Saturday, they'll be playing against Blake Griffin and the Detroit Pistons. Then on Monday, they'll take on Marc Gasol and the Toronto Raptors.
And going up against the Pelicans, this is one where it would take a complete meltdown for them not to come away with the win. Anything can happen, but I'd be shocked if they don't come out on top.
And Nash gets double teamed.
Hein? C'est quoi cette passe? Qu'est-ce qu'il nous a fait? C'était du pain béni. Enfin, j'avais une chance sur deux qui marque. Hein. Soit je lui donnais la balle, il fonçait sur le panier et il le mettait. Ah, putain, je sors. Non, je sors. Ah, c'est fini pour moi. On a gagné. Putain, c'est fini pour moi. Je suis dégoûté. J'ai pas fait mon double double. Oh les fautes. Non mais 5 secondes les gars. Même si tu mets un 3 points, c'est fini. Derrière, on n'a plus qu'à assurer et puis c'est bon quoi. Ah, la minute danse. Et ouais les filles, vous croyez que c'était fini? En fait non. Boum, le 3 points. Boum, le double pas qui fait bien, qui fait plaisir. Hop là! petite passe.
Here's Mitchell on deep.
Dommage. Ah, 1 seconde 7. Vas-y, tu le tentes.
And so it's Boston scraping by with the win. It was up for grabs, right?
Bon, j'ai fait 34-7. J'ai mis 34 points, mais j'ai pas fait mon double-double. Je suis un peu déçu.
Thank you, Kevin. Well, Che, big win for you and your team fighting in the playoff race. Coming down the stretch, does it feel like every game has that postseason mentality?
Alors, qu'est-ce que vous allez aborder les matchs à venir en pensant aux playoffs? Les playoffs sont déjà commencés pour nous. C'est sûr qu'ils sont plus intenses.
Absolutely, do man. Playoffs already start for us. We're so much on the line, you know, positioning and all that. We're approaching every game like it's do or die. Paid off for us tonight, man. Good job to my teammates. Shout out to the fans.
Well, you're still in it to win it, and you.
Thank you, David. Great interview once again.
Hey, hey, listen up. All right, game ball. Y'all know we don't do this every night, but when someone has an exceptional performance, we like to recognize it. So check.
C'est encore moi, homme du match.
Great game.
That's what's up, bro.
Appreciate it, guys, man. Look, yo, let's keep doing what we're doing, all right? I appreciate it, man. Yeah.
Eh oui, ce coup-ci, c'est à moi. Merci. Ils l'ont pas donné à Tatum ou à je ne sais qui parce que les mecs ils ont fait des ils ont fait je ne sais plus combien de rebonds, moult rebonds. Ah, c'est vrai que j'aurais dû me calmer à essayer d'avoir le ballon. Je devrais me calmer en fait en dernier carton. Disons que quand je suis à 4, faudrait que je me calme. Ils disent que je lâche trop tôt. Ouais, là c'était trop tard. Et là c'était un peu tôt.
Thank you.
Merde, j'ai fait que deux étoiles. J'ai pas fait gaffe. J'étais en train de me concentrer sur le timing et j'ai pas fait gaffe. Putain, faudrait que je green là. Non! Ah non, je suis déçu. La grave déçu. Je l'aurais mis au moins 2 points, ça passait, mais là. Je sais pas, je lâche trop tôt, on dirait. Ah ouais, je lâche trop tôt. Allez, nouveau match. À l'ouest, les Thunder, ils sont troisième. Bon, on va voir.
This is the 2KMC. Here to let you know what's going down in NBA 2K20.
Ouais, de toute façon, comme je disais, hein, faut. On prend les. On prend les matchs comme ils viennent. Boston, Massachusetts. And a look here at the scoring trend over the last several months for Nash. And it's really been a nice trend for him over these last several months. He's been. And with pregame routines coming to an end. Ouais. Apparemment, je joue de mieux en mieux. We have a lot of time left. David, thank you so much. Greg Che is off to a great start. For Che, I think it's all about fighting through the rookie wall. Et c'est parti pour un nouveau match. If he can do that, he's certainly in the mix. Oh, on est bon au niveau du truc, on est bon. And Adams, the combo out front. Gilgeous Alexander out there with Chris Paul. And it's Ferguson in at the three slot. And for the Celtics, Brown and Hayward, they're the wing. Tatum and Cantor together down low. And it's Che in at the point. Could be a transition free for all. Et où, mon bonhomme? What's your feeling about putain, non, 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 tu m'as pas mis le grand. Break, rather than taking it in for a higher percentage shot in the layup. Ouais, c'est vrai que je suis trop petit pour voir les rebonds. Joli. Joli le 2 points.
What's the decision making of the guy with the ball? Sometimes it'll be the point guard, it might be a wing player, but how smart is he at finding the right shooter at the right time at the three-point line on these fast breaks?
Making those big decisions, you're right.
Dessus les mecs, faut pas qu'il marque.
Ferguson kicks to Gallinari. Here's Adams. A second chance effort. It's good.
Tant pis.
He makes his first shot of the game.
C'est parce qu'il y a un succès Steam où tu dois mettre 10 points avant que eux en mettent 1 en fait. Ce coup-ci, c'est lui qui a fait l'erreur. Parce que j'ai pas demandé la balle.
And we say it time and time again, so I'll repeat it. Have to be careful with the ball, or this is what happens.
Just setting the tone with an aggressive move to the rack, and where's the help defensively?
Are you asking me, GA? I'm not sure.
And Paul gets it to go in.
And Paul takes pride in scoring past the defense. He's used to getting roughed up a little bit. Sometimes he causes most of that, though, Kevin. True grit from the little man.
Cantor, the pass to Chain. Unable to get
dommage.
Some solid D from Paul. And the foul.
Première, ouais, j'ai spammé.
That is his first foul of the game. On defense, Boston, trailing by two. Gallinari against Tatum. Pocket six. Nice shot by Gallinari.
Showing some nice body control, outstanding at keeping his composure and continuing to play at his speed is Gallinari.
Jay kicks to Tatum. Pass to Cantor. To the paint. Here's Jay. Paul with the defensive effort.
Well, that's how to protect the rim without fouling. Force him into an awkward release. And a bit of an adjustment on the layup.
T'es sérieux? Non, mais c'est pas possible. C'est quoi ce joueur? Je récupère le ballon, je lui fais la passe. Il trouve le moyen de... Et j'en fais une deuxième. Bah voilà. Pourquoi pas? Ah bah oui, au bout de la 2, il me sort. Pour mettre un avertissement, sûrement.
The Thunder leading by 5. All fueled up and ready to go. Let's reset the lineups courtesy of Gatorade as the second quarter gets going.
Oh non, non, j'arrête. C'est fini, j'appuie plus sur le bouton pour prendre le ballon. Ils ont clairement une technique contre moi. Mon bonhomme n'est pas dedans, je sais pas ce qui se passe, mais là.
Goes up at the stripe and too long on the shot.
Well, they shouldn't be giving that shot to anyone, but they certainly shouldn't be giving it to him. That's a big break for the defense.
On the sideline, let's catch up with Hall of Famer David Aldridge.
Thanks, Kevin. Che in the last game against the Jazz was terrific. He dropped in 34 points, and his hustle on the defensive end was amazing. He had a number of steals. It was another strong showing for him in what has quickly become a habit. Back to you, Kevin.
David, we appreciate the update. Greg, we'll see if he can keep rolling here tonight.
Yeah, and that's the rub. When he's in rhythm, he can carry your team across the line.
And you want to see him make sure that the teammates are also
trop tôt.
In what they're doing.
Oh, il est belle.
He draws that much attention. This is what he does. Find space on the
perimeter. Allez, belle, j'ai lâché trop tôt, mais
And so it's Schroeder with the ball. He'll bring it up for the Thunder. 4-point game. Their last encounter was in Oklahoma City.
Yeah, and their last time out against this club, turnovers really did them in. Just way too many mistakes.
Yeah, that had to have been number one priority for the coaching staff coming into this one. Limiting those turnovers and making sure they don't beat themselves this time.
Murray, no good.
And guys, you've heard of overpassing. Well, that shot was an example
Défense.
Of underpassing.
Maybe they can find a way
Joli.
To establish some rhythm in the next few possessions with the extra pass.
kicks to Nash. Over Paul. Shea, no good.
The Thunder. C'est dommage, je suis bon à cette distance-là, normalement.
Here's Ferguson. He had 10 points in the win against the Knicks in New York. The Thunder with another miss.
And you don't want to give up that kind of look too often.
Shea outside. Let's it go with a three. The shot misses. Now Oklahoma City takes it the other way. Schroeder with the ball. Guarded now by Nash. And that one's good. Schroeder.
They should continue to get the ball inside. The defense struggling to contain them.
Wanamaker looking over the floor. Now here's Williams. He's gotten some minutes, but nothing on the board yet. Another miss by Che.
This feels like it's snowballed a little bit on them. The more he tries to shoot his way out of this slump, the worse it seems to get. They need him to get it together.
The shooting numbers just aren't there yet in the quarter.
Here's Wanamaker. He's averaging a bit over 5 points a game. Pass to Che. There's the three. Busted. No good that time either.
He just doesn't look like himself this quarter. Something's missing.
Well, he's missing, and it's starting to affect a little bit in his body language, and you just don't want to see that.
Attendez, je reviens, ça va pas. Désolé, j'ai un voisin qui joue de la perceuse. Ah, la minute danse. J'ai dû fermer des portes, fermer des fenêtres.
Stretch of a game, and that's something that none of these guys can afford to have happen. If you're going to battle all the way to the finish, you have got to be hydrated. He's tried to get it going, but the shots simply have not been there. Nothing seems to be falling.
Ah, j'ai demandé la balle parce que j'ai cru qu'il allait rester coincé, mais en fait non. Ah, dommage. Ah, c'est bon.
Celtics trail by six. Nash dishes to Williams. From 13, that one off the back.
J'ai même pas le temps. Je lui donne la balle. J'ai pas le temps de faire un pas. Le mec m'a dé... Voilà, le mec m'a déjà redonné la balle tout de suite, en fait.
For an undersized player, Chris Paul's a pretty good finisher around the rim. Certainly knows all the angles.
Wanamaker, the pass to Williams. With the three, good. The nice assist.
Oh là là.
And I like the fact that he really was unfazed by that scoreless.
Ça rentre.
And now you can see him getting into a rhythm.
You know, Greg, for the Thunder fans, hard to see their star power dwindle, but they got a lot in return.
Yeah, but the Thunder were capped out. They hadn't made it past the first round in 3 years. And in exchange for Paul George, they got one of the richest trade packages in league history.
Ah non, il s'est fait voler le ballon.
Pass to Ferguson. Out to the wing. Corner shot. Rebound by Williams. Celtics trail by five. To the middle. It's stolen by Schroeder. And now the fast break. Schroeder with the ball. Che with the block.
Oh, joli.
Scouts were saying that Che didn't play with enough heart. That block showing you.
Oh non! Je lui ai donné.
Here's Schroeder. Doesn't go that time. Nice D from.
Putain, je lui avais donné. Enfin, en même temps, je lui ai donné en aller-oop, mais. Voilà.
You
Fallait que ça rentre. Le ballon était devenu toxique là. Il voulait pas rentrer.
It's deflected. Wanamaker the pass to Chain. And it's wide right. It's
non, mauvaise idée.
And not a night he's going to want to remember. Just not really able to score the basketball. And that one's good. Schroeder.
Ah non, là ça va pas. Hein. Ça va pas du tout. Hein. J'ai l'impression qu'on fait n'importe quoi. Faut calmer le jeu. On est dans. On est. Ah, c'est la minute danse. On est pris dans leur rythme. Ah bah ça va aller mieux, ils m'ont viré.
And he hits it to tie the game up. Nash has got 10 points in the quarter.
Scoring with the bump can throw your concentration off. Che right there, not distracted by contact.
Nash against Paul.
Ah putain, mais c'est pas possible.
Unselfish play of Chris Paul there has a knack for knowing when to get his guys when they're wide open.
Oh mais merde, c'est pas ça que je voulais faire.
135 left to play here in the half. Now here's Gilgeous Alexander. Started by Smart.
How about the timing he shows there to challenge that shot?
Yeah, not easy to do there, and that's a guy that you can tell takes every possession defensively very seriously.
The Thunder with the lead. Gilgeous Alexander with it. He has six. To the paint. Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot two.
Ah, purée, purée.
With the make them pay mentality right here from the free throw line.
Green, he's checked in for Boston. And he ends up missing both free throws.
And you look at the way Steven Adams has developed his offense the last few years. It's been a huge boost for this team. He has always been a great defender, but now he is an important cog on this team in terms of scoring.
And he lobs it up toward the rim.
Oh, and just a soft touch on both ends of that pretty alley.
I gotta say, when he threw the pass, I didn't know where it was going. Pass to Cantor. Nice ball movement by Boston. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot two at the free throw line.
Now, the great thing about the NBA is that you can prove yourself on a nightly basis. Chase Stock fell, staying 4 years in college.
Ah, dommage.
Analytics guys don't like the fact that as you get older, you maybe don't have the chance to reach a higher ceiling, but he's performed since he's entered the league.
Noel finds Paul. Here's Robertson. Back to Paul. Fires from deep. Rebounded by the Celtics. Cantor's got 5 rebounds tonight. Inside. Gilgeous Alexander with the steal.
Ah bah non, j'ai essayé le... Non! Oh purée!
Paul's got 18 points.
Nice job catch and shoot there. Chris Paul making it look simple and caught the defense.
Dommage. J'ai essayé le alley-oop, mais. Mais non, déception là-dessus, j'ai pas réussi. Ah, j'ai mis que 11 points, on est dans la merde! Putain, je suis le match d'avant, je suis l'homme du match. Je sais pas, quand t'es l'homme du match, t'es censé reproduire, réitérer le... comment on appelle ça? La performance.
You can get into a passing rhythm, and so far all of his have been on point.
And on the floor for Billy Donovan as we get into the second half. Gallinari and Adams, the combo out front. Chris Paul is out there with Gilgeous Alexander. And it's Ferguson in at the three, the small forward.
An explosive player who has no problem finishing above the rim. Tatum does damage inside.
And let's catch up with our sideline reporter, David Aldridge.
Well, Kevin, tampering is a touchy subject, but it's a word we're hearing more often. Teams want to retain their star players, but they know that there's always talk during a season. Now, teams can only express interest in a player when he hits free agency. Players can talk amongst each other freely all season.
Boom!
Star players like LeBron James are tied into their front offices. And some people wonder if there's much of a difference between what the player says and what this team is thinking. Kevin?
Good point, David. Thank you. Takes the 13-footer, and he connects with the jumper. And that's now 20 points for Chris Paul.
Just love to see Chris Paul operate in that area. Slows himself down. Great balance. It's one of his many strengths.
Brown feeling it out a bit. Shoots over Gilgeous Alexander. And it's Brown missing. Well, Thunder have gone 1-3 since starting the second half. Here's Ferguson, uses the glass to finish the layup. Ferguson's got 5 points so far.
Hey guys, the D has to show a little more fight on the
interior. Ah putain non. Le timing était pas bon. Defense les gars, defense.
He doesn't hit that one. And the Celtics going the other way now. At the elbow it's Jay. Brown right side.
Et voilà, ça rentre. Ah là là, non, le timing était pas bon. Juste au moment où je demande, il avait donné à l'autre derrière.
Friend, certain players make everyone around them better. Talk about some of those guys who will do that at the very highest level.
The interesting thing about today's game, Kevin, is it's not always the point guard position. I think in the past we thought two ways. The point guard, who has the ball in his hands, finding guys for them to make shots. And then through the 80s and 90s, it was low post players who were getting double teams and initiating some offense.
Yes.
Nowadays, it's a lot of wing guys. And it's guys like Kawhi Leonard, it's guys like LeBron James, Kevin Durant. Throw Draymond Green in there with his
ah non pass the ball. Ouais, ça c'est le problème avec les contre-attaques. Hein.
Into the gap. So, they look a little bit different, the initiators, in today's game.
Et ben voilà. Passe décisive. Ça monte.
He's just brilliant at jamming it down the defense's throat.
Gilgeous Alexander surveying the D. Here's Ferguson. Defended by Hayward. Adam. And foul on the shot. So he'll get a chance.
Ah, les fautes. Les fautes.
There in Steven Adams that you just have to pay attention to. Every night he's going to bang around the opposing big guys and be a threat.
Hey, il l'a pas mis.
Rim to score.
Joli.
Offensive rebound.
The Celtics making a switch here. Tice has checked in. Dennis Schroeder's checked in for Oklahoma City. And it's Schroeder with the ball. He brings it up for Oklahoma City. Pass to Adams. The dish to Schroeder. High arcing shot, and it's good on the way in. Schroeder's got 14 points for the game. And with Adams on the offensive glass, he is impossible to move.
Well, that's a big reason why a couple years ago, Kevin, he grabbed more offensive rebounds than defensive rebounds. So you know he's going to live in the paint.
Shot clock at 5. Here's Tatum.
Ah, Jason. Oklahoma City. Ah non, c'était pas Jason.
And here is Gilgeous Alexander. He has 6. And that one's good. Schroeder.
Trop loin, trop long pour sauter mon bonhomme.
He's making the defenders pay right now for all of the mistakes they're making.
Hayward passes to Nance. And that one is good.
Really wild to think.
Et ça rentre avec la faute.
Commitment to the game. He's proving himself and proving that he can hoop.
This is his third free throw attempt of the game. Austin making a switch here.
And one.
And a switch here also for Oklahoma City. Muscala's checked in. Now Schroeder.
Voilà, fonce.
It's stolen by Brown. And finished off by Brown.
So impressive, the fortitude, the will to battle back, but it did take a lot of energy to get here.
Well, they didn't really have a choice at the position that they were. They had to fight hard. They've gotten that. They've outworked the other team just fighting tonight.
So it's the Celtics now.
Putain, c'est pas lui, je voulais la remettre.
Kicks it over to Nash. Back to Tice. For the lead. They get it back.
Joli. Joli pour une fois qu'on avait le rebond.
Tice has got the lead up to two now for Boston.
Well, we've seen that movie a few times, haven't we? An easy bucket.
Oh, ah d'accord, c'est le bouton, c'est le même bouton pour prendre la balle que pour sauter pour la récupérer. Mon bonhomme, il a fait un vol plané.
Oklahoma City has gone 1-3 from downtown since halftime. It's a floater. Rebound Boston. Tice has got his 7th rebound of the game with that last one. Walker in the corner.
Oh mais non, mais c'est pas à lui que je voulais le faire.
To halt the run. Shooter passes to Muscala. Now here is Gallinari. He's got 7. 5 on the clock.
Ça c'est relou ça, je veux le faire à l'autre juste devant moi et
from deep 3 point range. Here's Adams.
Putain, et puis je suis trop petit. Putain, je veux le faire au bonhomme juste devant moi, il le donne à l'autre là-bas au fond.
Outside Walker. Here's Che. He's got 16. Back to Walker. It's tipped and the ball travels out of bounds. His last touch by Schroeder.
Ah mais le mec aussi.
Look here at some of the numbers for Che.
The most positive thing about his last 10 games, the work on defense. His mindset has become very aggressive. The steals are up and he's becoming a big factor on the defensive end.
Passes to Adams.
Sut.
Kicks it out to Schroeder. Over Tice. But they recover it. Out to the right wing. Now here's Gilgeous Alexander. He's covered closely. Here's Muscala.
Ah, just sut.
Here's Adams.
Oh là là, ça c'est un peu décevant. On se bat, on se bat, on se bat, et puis finalement ils y arrivent quand même.
Time called here. The Celtics decide to talk it over. Bring, you know, the moving screen is one of those very difficult judgment calls, isn't it?
It's a tough one, Kevin. But what you look for all the time in replays when you see that call.
Encore de la minute danse. C'est moi ou on balance plus de t-shirt?
And Kevin Garnett was the biggest problematic moving screen setter that I ever saw, being 6'11 and spreading out those sticks of his. But
oh, il rentre.
Wired in the shoulder, impossible. And then the hip move as the defender is moving around.
Elle rentre malgré la faute. Tu vois? Oh là 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 là.
Those are the ones where the referees, I think, are most in tune to in order to blow the whistle.
Même pas, j'ai envie de regarder jusqu'au bout parce que.
Stolen by Nash.
Oh, tiens.
For Williams.
Voilà.
This has been a great job of just getting into the middle of that defense and really scoring effectively from the paint.
Schroeder with the ball. 17 points in the game from 13 and he hits the jump.
Ah les gars, vous étiez au moins 3 là. Dis-moi pas qu'il n'a pas un qui peut. Ah, c'est dommage. Là, c'est dommage.
Adams with the slam. That gives him the double-double, 11 points and 10 rebounds.
Well, not many times does Adams get his number called for...
Ah, c'est dommage!
Oop, there, look good.
Gallinari down low, defended by Nash. Carter passes to Adams. For the lead, and that's...
Ah, lui aussi, je trouve, il est petit aussi.
Adams has got 9 points now in just the second half.
Wow, has he flipped the switch at halftime? Much more effective here in the second half.
Ça, ça m'énerve, ça. Ça m'énerve quand je suis petit et que les mecs ils me défoncent.
Here's Robertson. And out of bounds as the Celtics gain possession. And now look at Boston's upcoming schedule. On Tuesday, they'll be taking...
C'est quoi pour Pacers, Bucks, Wizards et Bulls?
On Thursday, they'll be matching up against Eric Bledsoe and the Milwaukee Bucks.
And they are looking at a ton of road games in the next stretch, but this team shouldn't fear...
Qu'est-ce qu'il fait? Pourquoi il recule? Non! Merde, hein! Là, je suis pas d'accord! T'étais tout seul! Et voilà!
Celtics trail by three. Williams dishes to Green. A drive by Chain.
Oh putain, puis si c'est pour redonner la balle alors que je te l'ai donné, non, abuse pas.
And guys, the defense has been no match. They've just picked them apart.
Chain outside.
Green!
Nash has got 11 points.
Hello!
Watch out. Now that
he's... Alors. Oh, c'est joli. Oh, c'est dommage. Allez, bouh. Bouh. Bouh, tu le mets pas.
Schroeder, it's really about consistency, Kevin.
Ennis Kanter's checked in for the Celtics. Marcus Smart comes in for Walker. And Oklahoma City with a change here too. Hall's checked in for Gallinari.
Non mais t'es sérieux, maintenant lui il se fait bâcher comme ça. Putain, mais pourquoi tu me redonnes la balle de... Mais c'est pas possible, tu... J'ai jamais vu un joueur de basket se débarrasser aussi vite et autant du ballon, quoi. Oh, bon, vas-y, oublie-moi.
Smart passes to Kanter. 6 on the shot clock. And that'll be 2 free throws.
Putain, les mecs, j'arrête pas de me faire... Tiens, Dark, si t'es encore là, essaye de me traduire, s'il te plaît.
And if those numbers show us anything, it's how good he is at picking up on ball handler's tendencies and knowing when to make his move.
Gordon Hayward's checked in for Green.
Ah bah voilà, les deux ils
rentrent. Schroeder
passes to Adams. Dishes at the ball. Back to Adams. And Kanter pulls it down. Kanter's got 8 rebounds in this game.
Oh joli.
And slam dunk by Tatum.
Joli pour une fois qu'il fait pas n'importe quoi. Ah non, je crois qu'il vient de rentrer.
Tatum against Schroeder for the lead. Goes up and lays it nice and easy. Tatum's got 6 points in the quarter.
A guy who has lived up to lofty expectations. Tatum impacts the game across the board.
Schroeder against Smart. Schroeder out. wrong side. Passes to Paul. Here's the three. That shot is off. Shea, he's feeling it tonight, and he's been the driving force for the Boston Celtics. He has really delivered at the offensive end. He's torched them for 24 points so far. We've got more in store for you right after this.
OK.
And how about a look now at our assist of the game?
Brought to you okay, by yeah, State Farm.
Just true artistry right there. I mean, great decision on where to go with the ball, and how about the perfect delivery?
Yeah, those are the kind of plays that you want to
play. Ouais, c'est moi qui fais la passe du match avec la fin de shoot.
We've reached the fourth quarter, and what has been a very competitive game should be an exciting finish. Tatum and Kanter together.
Oh là là, de tension, Jason. Non, c'était pas Jason. C'était, je sais plus comment il s'appelle, mais... Génial.
Celtics leading by four. Here's Smart. And the layup is good after a nice lead pass. Smart's got his first 2 points of the night.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
Paul outside. Here's Ferguson, defended by Hayward. Ferguson kicks to Paul. 1 minute now into this fourth quarter, and it's out of bounds. Oklahoma City able to retain possession here. And so here is Oklahoma City. They trail by six. And here is Noel, four on the shot clock. And two free throws coming.
Oh la faute, bah oui. On l'a vu hein, que tu l'avais poussé, Jason.
Well, it's been up and down the last few years for Nerlens Noel, but there are still some impactful numbers for the minutes that he's on the floor as a rim protector.
Le tremblement, j'ai pas l'impression que ça serve beaucoup.
Nerlens Noel, since coming into the league, seemingly has fought an uphill battle to try to find a role on a team where he can consistently make key contributions. Let's hope it's now.
And for Noel, his numbers will never match the visual impact he has on the floor, would you say?
Oh, he's definitely a player about the little things out there, just being a rim protector, making sure the guys think about him when they're attacking the rim. Not sure if he ran out of energy at halftime or what, but so far just not himself in the second half.
Ah dommage, je pense qu'il attendait le alley-oop, mais ouais si c'est le alley-oop. Je pense que le alley-oop ça aurait fait ça l'aurait fait, enfin quoi que je suis maintenant. Je suis plus sûr de rien.
Last quarter of play, about 2 minutes in now. The pass to Noel. Kept alive. Off target at the rim.
We'll have a hard time shaking that one off. Perfect position. Plenty of space. Just clanked it.
Nash drives in. Here's Kanter. Off target there. That would have pushed the lead to double digits.
Not great numbers, but great effort in this one. Sounds funny, but
ah,
I think
putain,
he's been a positive
de merde.
One of the more skilled offensive players that is on the floor here tonight, Kevin. Not an easy fella to hold in check.
Feeds to Smart. Nash against Paul. Out to Hayward.
Pourquoi j'ai fait une passe à lui alors que je voulais pas faire une passe à lui?
Over Paul. The shot's good from Gordon Hayward.
Bon, il l'a mis, c'est déjà bien, mais c'est pas ça qui va me faire rentrer mes passes décisives.
Gilgeous Alexander passes to Adams. He dishes it to Paul. Elbow shot is on the way, and the jumper is on the mark. Paul's got 24 points.
That's nice vision there. You see that pass, you make the feed before the defense has a chance to react, and that opens up a much better opportunity to score.
Noel against Tatum. Oh, and the jam by Tatum.
Tell you what, don't sleep on Tatum. He has some ups. And I love seeing him trying to electrify the crowd.
C'est vrai que là-dessus, je suis pas l'homme du match, hein, mais ah, pourquoi mon fils se prend toujours dans ma roue? Allez les filles, c'est de la danse.
Oklahoma City also making a switch. Gallinari's checked in. Okay, well, let's check in with David Aldridge, who's reporting from the sideline.
Well, over that last break, Kevin, I got a chance to listen to what Billy Donovan said to his team. He said, we're getting some looks on the three, but we're not connecting. But don't get frustrated. He told them it's a game of ebbs and flows.
Voilà, comme ça, Jason Tatum va être l'homme du match.
A tough first half, but it's been a different story here since the break. To Gilgeous Alexander. Paul against Nash. And it's Paul missing. Celtics leading by 8. Down low. Cantor trying to.
Oh no!
Nash's shot is off. And so it's Paul with it, bringing it up for Oklahoma City. Gallinari passes to Paul. And Tatum pulls it down.
Bon, faut que j'oublie les. Faut que j'oublie les rebonds en fait. Ah putain! Gâche trop tôt!
Well, it's about the defensive end, and that's what guys feed off. He gives the effort down there at all times.
Je relâche trop tôt.
Room for that release. He's gonna take those all day long.
Here's Brown. Ah, dommage! La grosse faute là.
Getting to the line.
That free throw good from Brown. He's off on the second. Thunder trailing by 7. Here's Paul.
Oh, il a sauté 10,000 ans trop tard, Jason.
Got 12 points here in the second half.
Well, the rest of the team has looked pretty bad tonight, but he's done a fantastic job of scoring the ball.
Ah, dommage.
And carrying the load on offense.
And so it looks like the Celtics will retain possession here. Paul against Nash. Over Paul.
Man, when a guy oh non, je suis nul.
Hustling out there, it's going to inspire the rest of the team, blitzing the shooters well with his quickness.
And it's Gilgeous Alexander in the corner. Launches it. Paul's shot is off.
He got off to a terrific start from the perimeter, but in the second half, he can't seem to build on that early success.
Inside, here's Nash, banked in off the glass. Nash has got 30 points.
I like his demeanor right now, too. Che letting his game do the talking. He's pouring it in right now.
Here's Paul. Again, the Thunder score.
What a great play. Totally schooled the defender on that one.
And out of bounds as the Thunder gain possession. Kicks to Ferguson. Gallinari against Tatum. And it's Gallinari missing. Celtics leading by 5. Pass to Nash. To the inside. Here's Tatum. Good, and the assist goes to Che. Che's got assist number 8 now on the night. Oklahoma City's gotten off to an 0-for-2 start from downtown here in the fourth quarter. Pass to Gilgeous Alexander. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line. It goes on Jason Tatum.
Gilgeous Alexander does a good job of
aggressive,
and that just forces the defense to do something.
And he's good on the second.
You move with him. Oh, you know.
The Celtics have gone 8-13 from the field since the start of the fourth, sinking the majority of their shots. Here's Nash. A good finish at the rack off the slick feet. Shaves got the lead up to 8 now for Boston. The Thunder shooting a respectable 47% from the field in this one.
Hey, retour en zone.
There, that'll be a backcourt violation.
Trying to come back, Kevin, and you can't afford too many mistakes. His fourth turnover hampering their effort.
To the paint, trying to find Kanter. Gets it to him.
Magnifique. Shot goes in. Passe décisive. Non, ça marche pas. Pas quand il y a une faute.
From the free throw line. Really good work here in the second half.
Thunder trailing by 11. Paul looking around. Oh, the lob to Gallinari. That shot off the mark. Great D that time.
Heureusement que le alley-oop il a pas marché.
Passes to Tatum and slam dunk by Tatum.
Ouais, ils auraient peut-être pu faire un alley-oop, mais j'ai pas tenté. Mon bonhomme il est tellement mauvais que voilà. De temps en temps ça passe et de temps en temps c'est à l'ouest.
There's Gallinari with the three. A shot that time, not on target. And it's Boston the other way. Up next for them is the Pacers.
Ah non.
That'll be the first half of a two-game trip.
Vu qu'il était devant, j'aurais pas dû faire un. Allez, ça c'est moi. Mais non, c'est... Oui, je suis pas resté appuyé sur le bouton. Je serais resté appuyé sur le bouton, j'aurais pu lui donner pour faire ma passe décisive. Oh, joli. Il a tenté. Et voilà. J'ai fait mes 10. J'ai fait mon quota.
Tatum keeps his defenders on edge with so many moves with the ball.
Time called here. The Thunder decide to talk it over.
And they're allowing too many points in the paint.
Ah là là, ça se passe bien, ça se passe bien.
Hear about it.
Yeah, coach knows that. They know that. In the timeout, they're going to hear about it and make the adjustment.
And now let's present our Jordan player of the game.
Ah, l'homme du match. 3 points. Boom. Hop, il récupère les ballons.
Trois points.
Et dis donc, il est énorme ce match. Ce match, ce joueur.
Here's Ferguson. Passes it to Paul. And another steal for him.
Ah, l'interception.
Imposing his will at the defensive end.
Joli le alley-oop.
Perfect alley-oop. You gotta love that.
A little surprise, Greg. He didn't go for the big
shot. Je l'ai vu partir, j'ai dit je tente, hein. Oh là là. Qu'est-ce qu'il met? Mais dis donc, il a les mains baladeuses. Je suis revenu là, je suis revenu. Ah, joli. Joli ton 3 points. Pourquoi je suis pas logique, j'essaie de prendre des rebonds alors que bah, je suis pas équipé pour quoi. Rebond défensif si je peux. Enfin je peux. Oh joli. Non tu... Ouais voilà, mais tu peux pas louper ça. Putain j'ai... Il m'a loupé ma passe décisive.
Everyone who watched it, just a total mismatch and a true show of strength for the Celtics.
And guys, the fast break was run, I thought, beautifully all night by these guys. I think that was a big part of their success.
Yeah, they definitely ran the break well, a big advantage in that category, and they continually put pressure on the defense.
And when it's all said and done here, this will mark their 38th W on the year.
Really, they had their number this season. Two wins, a home win, and an away win.
And a lot of players tonight helped contribute to this performance. But in particular, a real good game it was for Jay.
So sharp on the passing tonight. You know, guys can get into a rhythm that way, too.
And okay, going with a whole new group out there.
So we oh, je suis déçu. As the second one misses. Moins d'une minute. Merde, c'était mon bonhomme.
Working on green, shot good by yellow.
That's the kind of passing right there
pour
that makes a difference. Not just in that possession, but maybe on your play for the entire game.
On the wing, Williams. Outside, Green. There's the dish to Che. Three-pointer. It's rebounded by Oklahoma City.
Ouais, j'ai mal fait.
He's a shooter that the D has to close down on quickly when he's ready.
J'aurais pas dû shooter, mais bon.
It's clear Robertson just knows his strengths and stays within himself. Good job of recognizing how to score.
Outside Green.
Pourquoi les mecs qui me redonnent le ballon à chaque fois?
Jay outside. Off target from outside. And so it's Boston easily grabbing this one. This game may not have been the most exciting we've ever seen, but you have to appreciate just what a clinical performance they put on.
On a gagné. Meilleur du match en passe décisive, meilleur du match en 3 points. Ah voilà, j'ai fait tous mes quotas. Interview, comme d'hab.
Congratulations on another victory tonight. How is this team using games like this to prepare for the playoffs?
Comment ces matchs pourront aider l'équipe à se préparer aux playoffs?
Hey, games like this are a great chance for us to work on the little nuances. You know, work out any kinks. We want to stay sharp and be our best when the postseason comes around.
Well, it's certainly coming up.
David, thank you as
well. Yo,
home.
Yo, listen up. I want to handle the game ball real quick. Now, I think we all know who earned
it. Bah, bien sûr, c'est mérité.
Hey. You busted your behind.
Quoi?
On both sides of the floor. Nice work, man. Sorry.
Good job, boy.
T'es sérieux, là? Vas-y, c'est bon, tu m'as dégoûté. Vas-y, c'est bon, je suis déçu. Vas-y, déçu, quoi. Meilleur aux 3 points, meilleur au... Passe décisive... Le mec qui a fait 3 rebonds, quoi, c'est bon quoi. Il devrait toujours me donner le ballon du match. Je devrais être gavé de ballons chez moi. Quoique, c'est pas plus mal en fait. C'est quoi, homme du match, il file le ballon, tu mérites le ballon du match, machin. Et tu les fous après chez toi, t'en as une flopée. Et chaque ballon sont marqués de... De la date et de l'équipe contre qui on joue. Après, au cours d'une saison, tu te retrouves avec je sais pas combien de ballons dans ton garage ou. Faut prendre que les importants quoi, ceux du playoff ou le ballon pour le truc de l'année quoi. Ouais, j'ai fait ça, j'ai demandé la balle parce que le mec il bouge même pas, il aurait laissé passer les 24 secondes. Putain, le mec il fait n'importe quoi, il me voit en galère, il me voit qu'il peut pas passer la balle. Tu donnes à ton copain ou je sais pas. Oh, le mec il se fait une percée tout seul quoi. Eh ouais les gars. J'ai tendance à relâcher trop tôt en fait. Eh ouais, ça c'est encore une erreur que je viens de faire. Je demande le ballon alors je me recule. Purée. Et on a perdu. Putain. Au lieu d'assurer, je sais pas. Ouais, ouais, il me faut faire ça parce qu'ils savent que c'est mon gros point faible. Ah non, j'ai sauté trop tôt.
Get to work. Here's what we're gonna do. You got it. You got it. Come on, man.
Alors, ouais, ça se... Comment on appelle ça? Donc, pour l'instant, bah, j'ai gagné mes deux matchs. Le deuxième, c'est vrai que c'était mal parti. Mais disons qu'après on a bien défendu et ça s'est bien... On a clairement bien remonté. Puis après une fois que j'étais plus sur le terrain, pareil, ils ont bien remonté le score. Prochain match, bah pareil, hein, faut qu'on joue bien, faut qu'on assure. Faut qu'on assure pour mettre comment ça s'appelle ? Faut qu'on assure qu'on joue bien pour toujours engendrer des points et rester le. Rester le plus haut possible dans le tableau. Si on peut monter, on montrera. Mais ouais, sinon le mieux ce serait de garder notre place actuelle. Cinquième, c'est bien. on est dans le top 5. Bon, après, oui. Le mieux, ce serait le top 3 et le must du must, ce serait premier, mais bon. Tout en sachant que j'ai pas un bonhomme qui... Mon bonhomme n'est pas maxé en fait, je suis pas à 99. Donc ouais, j'ai le temps. J'aime bien comme ça. Ouais, c'est... J'ai progressé, je... Oh putain, non. Ah, j'ai même pas fait un green. Ah, puis j'ai loupé. Il y avait une chance de remonter. Ah, 100 points, quoi. Par contre... Ah, merde, j'aurais pu avoir un badge. Bon, c'est pas grave. Alors, les Pacers, ils sont où? Ils sont 12e. D'accord. Bon, on va voir, hein. 12e, normalement... Il y a moyen que ça se passe bien. Ah, hymne national. We'll be right back with more. Hold on tight and don't go away. Belle voix. Toujours, c'est toujours la même qui chante. Sur tous les matchs. Pourquoi? On ne sait pas. Elle est peut-être attitrée. Hi everyone, we're coming to you live. Chanteuse de hymne national attitrée. Ah, regarde, j'ai progressé. 10 points par match en décembre. Je suis monté à 29 points en janvier et à 31 en février.
David, thank you. So let's take a look at the Boston Celtics starting lineup.
Brown and Hayward. Allez, c'est parti. Tatum and Cantor together down low. Et encore un nous. Oh, par contre, le parquet est clair, hein.
Sabonis and Turner up front, and it's Holiday in at the three. In watching Jaylen Brown, sometimes, you know, Billy looks like a future star. Other times, he struggles. Now, he's only a couple years into this league, and I get that, but what do you think he needs to do to gain more consistency with his game?
Le parquet est clair. Oh là.
The last 4 months of the season, he became a really good two-way player.
Commence pas à laisser passer.
Potentially is Paul George, because he had a lot of the same checkpoints that Paul George did. Paul George is somebody that the first couple years of his career didn't go to the line very much, which I always like to look at to see, especially with a forward, if they're going to actually become a real scorer. You want those free throw attempts to be kind of in the 7, 8, 9 range. Jaylen Brown doesn't get to the line. But Paul George didn't either. I think he's such a good athlete. He's a really smart basketball player. And I think he plays hard. I think that was a weird situation that he was in last year. And he was one of the only ones that got better as the year went on.
He plays hard. You saw something in his eye. I don't think he liked coming off the bench.
He didn't.
Attends, on a toujours pas mis le... No one to blame on that le premier panier. You get looks like that, you've got to take advantage. Ah, c'est moi qui devais ouvrir. Joli. The Celtics shooting their first free throw tonight. Putain, le gars, c'est moi qui lui fais la passe. Qu'est-ce qu'il fait? Il check avec Tatum. Je sais pas, tu viens me checker tranquille, quoi.
For Indiana, they've gone 0-3 from the field to start the game. Brogdon kicks to Sabonis. Brown against Oladipo. Back to Sabonis. Pass to Oladipo from 20 feet out. And Cantor pulls it down.
Not sure what the D was doing there. Clearly a breakdown. You can ill afford to give a guy like him that good a look. Nice play, and you can see they're gathering momentum.
You know, they need to stay aggressive here. Build the lead up while they've got the chance. Don't waste this opportunity.
Oladipo against Brown. Oladipo misses.
Yeah, trying to get going here, but that's an offer for the first five.
Le alley-oop.
Basketball historian, we know that. Do fans romanticize too much about the past?
I would say the other way. I think they don't appreciate it enough, especially like the millennials and Gen Z. You know, you're out there, you're playing this game right now. They tend to think the league started when Kobe showed up and that the 90s and the 80s didn't happen. I sense a real resentment from the younger fans with the LeBron versus MJ thing, because LeBron's their guy. They get to watch LeBron. They don't
oh non, il l'a mis! Putain, il m'a niqué! Putain, je suis déçu.
Oh yeah.
My goodness, you talk about some of these players. Unbelievable.
Yeah, the 60s, 70s, 80s. I think part of what hurts.
Je suis déçu parce que je voulais faire mon 10 points sans qu'il en mette un quoi. Et je serais resté devant lui j'aurais peut-être eu le rebond quoi.
Sabonis. Celtics leading by 8. Outside Tatum. In the corner it's Hayward. 18 feet out. That one doesn't go.
Putain, j'aurais eu mon succès Steam.
Last time they met was right here and they came out with the win.
And the last meeting of these two teams, they were really sharp defensively, disrupting the flow of their offense and causing a ton of turnover.
Very satisfying performance, Greg, and one they'll look to repeat tonight. I mean, they ended up winning it going away.
And he sinks the second.
And you know, je suis grave déçu.
16-17 rookie of the year continues to impress. Brogdon is a valuable role player who does a lot of things well.
Tatum on the wing. Over Brogdon. Good D by Brogdon. Pacers trail by 7. To the middle. Good, and it's Oladipo picking up the assist. Brogdon's got 6 points.
Boy, I love how unselfish Oladipo is. Great at getting his teammates involved and on time, on target passes.
Shea outside. And they call the foul, so he's got the and one chance here to make it.
C'est comme je l'avais mis dans le vent.
And Gordon Hayward, obviously a tremendous performer. Bill, where do you rank him against other wings in the NBA now?
Probably one of the best.
Fait chier, j'ai pas pu mettre mon
endoine. And I think it's pretty easy to forget that there's a reason the Celtics are paying this guy almost $30 million a year. He was one of the top 15 players in the league. He was a borderline franchise player on a top 8 playoff team, and he's just really good and he's efficient. So when you talk about a team like the Celtics where, you know, you gotta share the ball, Tatum needs more shots, everybody's gotta have a little, he's the perfect guy to have because he's happy going 8 for 15.
Oladipo outside, and there's the feed to Holiday. Sabonis trying to get open, doesn't get it to drop for him. Hayward with some nice D. Here's Nash. Good work defensively by Turner.
I think he'll think twice about attempting that shot next time. The defense was right on top of him there.
Holiday dishes to Oladipo. Holiday against Brown. Holiday, the pass to Sabonis. 6 to shoot. Now, here's Brogdon, defended by Nash.
A shot like that is a polite way to say, hey, coach, bench me.
Hey, that's crazy there. I mean, insanity. At least wait until you get across half court.
Il aurait peut-être pas dû demander la balle.
Brogdon outside. Indiana again missing.
You know, he looks a little off kilter to me this quarter, still trying to find his rhythm.
And he did everything he could to make that shot as difficult as possible.
And you know what, guys? That will pump him up because he takes a ton of pride in what he does on defense.
Oladipo, the pass to Holiday. Indiana needs to get a shot off. Stolen
Joli.
By Kansas. And here comes Brown, leading the fast break for the finish. And
ouais, j'allais dire. Tu peux conclure sans moi.
And Bill, when you yourself get out on the court, is there a play you try to channel or emulate, or try to visualize in your mind?
You mean when I'm playing pickup?
Yes. Yes.
Oh, well now at this point in my life, it's Davis Bertans. Is that how you say his name?
Yeah. Huh? Davis Bertans.
Davis Bertans?
Yeah. And for those of you just joining us, we're almost 2.5 minutes into the second quarter.
Oh la la.
Boy, patrolling the paint well, protecting the rim, that's exactly the kind of defensive effort you need against him.
Je lui donne la balle, le mec il le met pas. Ça donne même plus envie quoi. Ça donne plus envie de donner la balle.
Thanks, Kevin. Che in the last game against the Thunder was outstanding. He had 35 points and seemed to pick apart the defense all night with a ton of assists. The numbers in that game make me anxious to see what he can do tonight. Kevin?
Yeah, David, in stretches, he was absolutely dominant. Great. He'd love to match that performance tonight.
This team needs his contributions. When he's right, he makes winning plays.
Je vais donner la balle à quelqu'un d'autre. Ou alors je vais la garder moi-même, pour moi-même.
That it opens up opportunities for others.
And you don't ever want to get into the habit of letting the offense get to the rim.
Yeah, I couldn't agree with you more. I mean, that's the message they were sending with that foul. Nothing easy inside.
Hayward on the wing. Back to Nash. Takes the three. The basket good off the assist from
Hayward. Et le green. C'est joli ça.
That pass is right in Che's shooting pocket. He's not going to waste any time rising up for the Che.
And pushing it up, here's Boston. Looks good, is good. Bucket number 4 from the field. He's taken only 6 shots. And now we'll get a perspective here on the hustle game, how it's been going for the Celtics.
Well, I think the defensive aggressiveness on display here has caught him off guard, playing airtight defense and coming up with the steal.
And also, how about the fact defensively,
ouais, getting that back. Le petit batch pit pocket, ça marche très bien.
Especially in this first half. 4 on the clock. Oladipo for 3. Another shot. Sabonis, no good.
Boy, that's a look. He has to finish, and he knows it. Blown opportunity.
Here's Hayward. The rebound by Brogdon. Brogdon's got 4 rebounds in this game. Down low, Turner. And it's slammed in by Turner.
This is putain, on est censé être en défense, et enfin, une contre-attaque, on était bien, et qu'est-ce qu'il fait, lui? Il laisse passer dans mon dos, quoi.
Well, it's definitely the reason I like sports as much as I do, because it's so sports obsessed. A lot of it is cold weather stuff, I feel like, where there's 5 months a year that just stink, and then there's 3 other months that, you know, it's just smoking hot and humid. And so the sports makes everybody kind of crazy, because you're crazy anyway. But there's nothing like being in Boston when something good's happening, like Celtics making the NBA playoff run, or the Bruins making a cup run. The Red Sox in September when the Yankees are coming to town, or the Saturday before a Patriots game, you can kind of feel it as the community of it. That's the difference between here and a place like LA.
It's formed you as a professional.
Absolutely. Yeah.
He is never going to pass up a chance to attack. I mean, that's Che's mindset and mentality. Use movement to put the defense in a tough spot.
No wasted trips at all. They're taking care of business.
Eh oui, ça se passe comme ça.
One way to protect the lead, knock down those free throws, and 100% free throwing for the quarter. That's superb.
Nice ball movement by Boston.
Ouais, je sais, j'ai fait n'importe quoi là.
Here's Holiday, and a
Normalement, on aurait dû le marquer le panier et j'ai fait n'importe quoi. J'ai demandé la balle alors que j'aurais pas dû.
Rebound Boston. Cantor's got 6 rebounds here tonight. Here's Che. The rebound by Turner. Turner's got his 6th rebound on the night. Che outside. And it's sent back.
Putain. Man, the defense. Il m'arrache la balle des bras.
I mean, he positioned himself well to come up with a lot of blocks. And slam dunk by Sabonis.
And didn't do anything fancy there, but didn't need to.
Nope, he is only concerned right now is getting the points on the board. And I don't mean style points.
Hey, I thought there was some style there, guys. What are you guys looking at? I mean, it was still a pretty sweet, flavorful one-hand flush.
Celtics have gone 9 of 10 from the line, so making the most of their chances.
We've got one of the hardest working players in the league at the line here.
Putain, le mec, il me savate, quoi.
On all aspects of this game.
Et moi je fais n'importe quoi, mais.
And Oladipo kicks to Brogdon. You know, Bill, you've seen Gordon Hayward work his way back from injury. How much longer do you think until he's 100% both physically and mentally?
Well, he's basically lost 2 years. You know, he lost the first year obviously because of the injury, and then the second year was really up and down, and he'd have these waves where he was confident for a week or two, and then it would just go away again. Heading toward the playoffs, he looked great. And then it went away again. Right. And I always felt like he had a little bit of PTSD from the injury, where there would be times where he just didn't want to drive in traffic and bounce off people and play in the air. And if you watch him in Utah, that was all the stuff that made him special. And he was a really athletic player. And when you lose that, it's hard to get back. It's hard to trust, like, when you land, somebody's foot's not going to be there.
It's like if you blew a knee, you're always worried about people down around you, right?
So the role model would be Paul George, because Paul George, you could see the first year he came back, was a lot of the same. You know, he was a little nervous in the air. He wasn't as physical as he used to be, and then it came back and then some. So the hope with Hayward is that that happens.
Ah, il y a de la chance de l'avoir mis, parce que putain, je suis juste devant, le mec il me la donne pas.
Oladipo, the pass to Brogdon. On the wing, Turner. And a great assist by Brogdon as that one goes in. Brogdon's got 4 assists in the game. Looking at the last game for the Indiana Pacers, it was a loss to Dallas.
Bad outing offensively. You break that game down, their issues were pretty clear.
Yeah, the offense was AWOL. It just wasn't there. No rhythm, no flow, just a tough.
Ah putain, l'autre il m'a pris mon bonhomme, c'était à moi de le garder. Oh, fait chier.
Coming from inside the paint now.
Celtics leading by 12. Jay, high post. 35 points for him last game against Oklahoma City.
And it was a huge night for him at the other end as well. How about the steals? And he was just a big headache the entire game.
Marcus Smart checked in for Boston. Nash against Brogdon. And it's sent back by...
Oh, comment tu t'es fait bâcher?
Here's Holiday. That one falls, his second basket of the game. He's now 2 for 3. Bill, you look at the awards given out by the league. Most have been around for a while. But is there any award that you'd like to add? Something that's not being touched on in terms of high performances and success?
I think that there should be a playoff MVP.
Merci.
I made this case
like
in my
idea.
Book.
That's
that
a great idea.
There's always like a best guy in every postseason. And I would like to see who that would be. And it's pretty easy to go backwards and figure out who it was. I did that. Just go backwards and have all the backstory of who it should have been, but then going forward, now here are the ones we're adding. I would like to see that. I would also like to see a best bench celebration award, because certain teams just have these guys. They're good at pointing.
Ce match-là, il a l'air de bien se passer.
First guy during the time. timeout, running over,
chest bumps,
they have handshakes.
All of it, yeah.
Enfin, je se passe bien parce que je fais énormément, on fait énormément de conneries, et moi beaucoup, et on a toujours une grosse avance sur eux, donc.
DeAndre Jordan, I think, was one of the first guys I remember who was just great at this before he started playing. Late 2000s clips. I was like, man, this guy's really, he's not playing, but he's really figuring out how to affect the game.
Good.
Passes it to Shea. Takes a three. Good, and Smart gets the assist. Shea's got a pair of triples in the second now for the Celtics.
Boy, has he put his foot on the pedal here this quarter. He's doing a terrific job in terms of leading their
J'ai spammé. Et donc quand tu spams, tu sors. Enfin, tu fais une faute et tu sors.
One second left. No good on that one. It's been all about Shea for Boston. That quarter had to take a lot out of him. He racked up 12 points. It's time now to go courtside.
Attends, j'ai mal vu.
You over to David Aldridge from the sideline.
Le mec s'appelait Dragon. Non, c'est moi qui ai mal vu. Interceptions. Non. Bonjour, c'est une intervention.
Well, I thought it was a great defensive performance for him so far. He's aware, he's alive, he's alert, quick to react to everything that's going on around him. Can't do it much better than that.
Sabonis and Turner up front. Ogden and Oladipo, the backcourt duo. And it's Holiday, and at the three, the small forward. So that's the group out there for Indiana. And it's blocked. Up top, Brogdon. He's covered by Cantor. Oladipo, good.
Boy, good shot selection there from Oladipo. Part of what makes him
on se reprend.
On offense.
Pass to Cantor. The kick out to Tatum. To Cantor. Brown, right side. And finished off by Brown.
Hey, I don't think there's any excuse for allowing Brown to get that deep. I mean, he's brilliant at throwing it down if the defense doesn't stop
it. Up top, Sabonis. Guarded by Tatum. Here's Brogdon. And Tatum pulls it down. Boston leading by 10. The pass to Shea. Here's the teardrop. That one drops for him. Shea's got 18 points.
Boy, that's real concentration there, guys. It's one thing to finish through contact right at the rim, but for Shea to do so outside of the paint, impressive.
Pass to Oladipo. To the inside. And the basket is good. Sabonis has got his second bucket tonight.
That's three of four here to start the half.
For Boston, they've gone two of three from the field to start the second half. Hayward on the wing, guarded by Holiday. Hayward can't hit. So Oladipo will bring it up for Indiana. It's a 10-point game. And they're off to Philadelphia after this game as they'll take on the 76ers. That will be a getaway game for them, a one-game road trip. And contact on the shot.
Putain, le mec, comment il me bloque, quoi. Il veut pas que je reçoive le ballon.
Yeah, I like the aggressiveness of Jason Tatum. He's looking for contact and doing a nice job drawing the fouls there.
The Pacers making a switch here.
Jason Tatum, zéro.
He's as solid as it gets from the line. I mean, give him the opportunity, he's cashing in on those.
Just over 2.5 minutes gone by.
Il est bien dans un dans les sports où le mec il a un zéro ou un double zéro.
You know, he's been off tonight, off his game. At this point, he might want to focus on creating for others.
Nash, the pass to Cantor. Nice ball movement by Boston. Out to Hayward. Back to Jay. The tray. The basket good off the assist from Hayward. Hayward's got three assists tonight.
Boy, for Jay, it's been one great play after another tonight. They cannot keep him in check.
Turner passes to Brogdon. And block. That one goes careening off the glass. Outside Holiday. Just 5 on the clock. Over Nash. Ball's knocked loose. Out of bounds. Boston takes possession. And now a chance to take a look at some numbers for Che.
The most positive thing about his last 10 games, the work on defense. His mindset has become very aggressive. The steals are up, and he's becoming a big factor on the defensive end.
He feeds it to Cantor. Misses from close range.
And not allowing the shooter even an inch of breathing room on that one.
And, guys, that's exactly the kind of high-impact defense they want to see out of him. Boy, that was a sweet-looking teardrop. There's very little defense for that.
Brogdon against Nash. Hayward from outside. The Pacers pull it in.
And they had some botched coverage that turned into no coverage.
Guys, they're looking for a way to score here.
Yeah, they've had a tough time taking the lid off.
The shot by Brogdon, no good.
Boy, this is bad. Tough to watch. I mean, this is really bad. He's stone cold, this boy. Man.
And he can do a lot more damage.
Non, je parle pas beaucoup. Hein. Là, je suis déçu. Des fois, tu fais des... C'est obligé que ça rentre, quoi. T'es un joueur de la NBA, merde.
Inside, here's Hayward. Good, and the assist goes to Che.
J'aurais pu faire un alley-oop, mais comme j'ai eu des mauvaises expériences et des très bonnes, voilà.
You know, he should be getting extra attention from the defense, not less.
Sabonis finds Brogdon. 11 feet away, Turner. He hangs in there and cashes in on the second chance points.
Boy, how about the determination of Turner? I mean, he's a wrecking ball on the glass on both ends of the floor. Just doesn't give up on plays.
Now a timeout called by Boston.
Bon, on est en troisième, ça se passe bien. Il y a des erreurs qui sont faites, mais dans l'ensemble, ça se passe bien.
Robert Williams is checked in for Cantor. Murray comes in for Gordon Hayward. And Brad Wanamaker subbed in for Brown. Here's Bembry. The rebound by the Celtics. And up the court come the Celtics on the break. Nash has got the ball.
Boy, a good example of attacking basketball in the open court. Che busting out and finishing on the break.
Holiday, the pass to Holiday. He can't hit that time. And it's Boston the other way. Here's Tatum. And slam dunk by Tatum.
And Tatum is a scorer, but he also has solid court vision. Really good job of using his quickness to penetrate to the basket.
Holiday looking over the floor. Over to the wing. Here's Bitadze. A rebound by the Celtics. Tatum's got 6 rebounds now in the game. Che passes to Williams. Good. And it's Che picking up the assist.
Voilà, passe décisive.
Second basket of the night. Pacers trail by 21.
Oh, comment il me...
Passes it to Sabonis. That one good for 2.
Yeah, I like Sabonis' game inside because he's confident and skilled.
Outside Tatum. And that one clearly a foul. Gets the whistle and 2.
Comment il s'est fait bâcher?
All right, well, a look at how the points have been generated so far.
Je sais plus c'est quoi son pouvoir, son takeover là, son attribut qui vient débloquer. Ah putain, ils m'ont sorti. Ah ça va, ça garde mon takeover.
Outside Smart. Outside Tatum looks for Nash, gets him now. The Celtics working the ball around now. Count that one. 6 points for Williams.
And after really leaning on that 3-point shot in the first half, seeming like they're just getting away from it here in the second. More of the shots coming from the interior.
kicks to Bembry. Rebound by Williams. Williams has got his fifth rebound in this one. Smart passes to Walker. Off the left rim and out. Pacers trail by 19. 1:44 left in the third. Oladipo misses. And so it's Walker with it, who brings it up for the Celtics. Outside Williams. Nash outside. Beyond the arc. Drains it from beyond the arc. Shaves got two now from beyond the arc in the third for the Celtics. Indiana's gone a less than productive 2 of 6 from three-point land in the second half.
Et moi, mon takeover, c'est un boost 3 points.
6 points for him.
Zone préférentielle.
6 on the shot clock. Bembry the pass to Leaf. Here's Oladipo. And the rebound goes to Nash. Austin leading by 22. Oh, Tatum in position.
Boom!
The alley-oop through.
And you know, if you throw le Tatum alley-oop.
He's a really good athlete. You can't let him roam.
L'alley-oop de ouf.
Here's Bembry, guarded by Walker. A wide open look here for Oladipo. No good again that time.
Yet that's another miss for him. They're behind in this game largely because he shot poorly.
And for the Pacers, they're shooting 4% to start the second half. That's the kind of start they were looking for.
And Tatum pulls it down.
Est-ce que c'est par rapport aux passes des joueurs?
No doubt the fight's there. They are trying to battle back, but he's just really struggling this quarter.
À un moment, il faut que. En plus, avec le 4, je pensais que j'allais avoir. C'est un bonus de shoot à 3 points après qu'un joueur t'ait fait une passe. Et en plus, comme j'ai déjà ce bonus là avec le catch and shoot, bah, je m'étais dit que. Voilà quoi. Que je suis invincible.
Oh,
il serait rentré, ça aurait été anthologique. Fin du troisième.
And let's go back to a terrific pass that we're calling tonight our State Farm assist of the game.
And I'm glad this was the pick because I love this pass. Such a great dish.
That's c'est moi qui fais la passe du match.
Go along with that vision. I mean, he put the ball in the absolute perfect spot. That's how you orchestrate it.
And there have been two very different performances from these teams today. As we get going in quarter number four. A moment now to reset the lineups brought to us by Gatorade. All fueled up here for the fourth quarter. On the floor for Boston. Brown and Hayward, the duo at forward. Kemba Walker is out there with Nash. And it's Cantor in at the center position. Turner passes to Brogdon. Lock at six. Shot from free throw range. Gordon Hayward comes up with the rebound. Hayward's got his seventh rebound here tonight. And Hayward with the stuff.
And I love the fact that he didn't have to slow down or adjust there. The pass was just timed.
Ouais, le roi du pad.
Indiana decides to talk it over. Shea really making a difference.
Just killing it.
They've
got to be all up in his jersey at all times. Give him even an inch.
Allez, la minute t-shirt.
Indiana making some changes.
Pour que les mecs y
restent. J.K.R. Sampson comes in for Doug McDermott. And Edmund Sumner's subbed in for Oladipo.
C'est dommage qu'on le voit pas le. Enfin, non, ils le font pendant la mi-temps. Ouais, j'ai laissé passer, mais c'est pas grave. Pendant la mi-temps, le kiss cam.
Brogdon is not the biggest guy, but that does not stop him from being aggressive and assertive inside.
Là, je conseille de regarder sur internet, sur YouTube, les compilations de kiss cam. Il y en a des pas mal.
We're still waiting for that first miss from the line this half.
Et le truc aussi avec les mascottes. Je crois que c'est un peu préparé.
Outside Green. Back to Jay.
Ah, dommage.
Brogdon's got his eighth rebound here tonight. Now the pass to Sumner. Feeds it to Turner. And stolen by Jay. Here's Wanamaker. Again, the miss by the Celtics. Pacers have gone 2 of 3 from the field to get the fourth quarter start. Here's Sumner, and he drops it in from the low post.
Putain, je suis content, j'étais sur l'interception. Neither did the defenders.
Nash against Brogdon. The feed now to Green. Played in with a nice touch off the glass.
Yeah, taking it right into the teeth.
C'est magnifique.
And it's a defense that's starting to look frustrated.
Well, they should be. I mean, it has not been a good performance for them at that end of the
floor. Oh putain. Back to Brogdon. Ah, je fais la faute. Mais il est parti d'un coup. Ah, j'ai fait la faute parce que j'étais en retard, mais bon.
And some changes here for the Pacers. Sabonis, he's checked in for Johnson. Justin Holiday comes in for Jakar Sampson. And it's Victor Oladipo in for Edmund Sumner.
Oh putain, enfoiré.
Here's Brown. That shot missing. So the Pacers will take it the other way. And Brogdon, here we go. Yep, it counts. And that's now 9 points for Sabonis.
That's serving it up on the platter there. What a nice pass. A high percentage look was the result.
And they double up Jay. Here's Cantor. And Cantor throws it down.
Yeah, he's shown terrific control of the pace and the rhythm of this offense.
You know, numbers don't always tell the story, guys, but his assist total.
Ça se passe très bien. Ça se passe très bien. Et j'aime quand ça se passe très bien. Bon, mais en même temps, oui, si au point de vue défense, je suis pas bon.
Just awesome speed from Brown, blasting off towards the bucket and slamming it down.
Mais où mon bonhomme, il est là?
Brown against Oladipo. Pass to Brogdon. From downtown, and Cantor pulls it down. Cantor's got 11 rebounds in the game. Here's Tatum, and there are the Celtics with another basket.
Oui, j'étais au rebond parce que j'ai pas confiance en toi.
Tatum, guys, staying aggressive and keeping constant pressure on the defender.
Nabbing another steal. And that's his sixth steal of the night.
Imposing his will at the defense.
Ah, dommage.
And the activity he shows around the rim is why he is such a respected defender.
And you know what? He's not going to give up an easy finish at the rim. I mean, that's just against his constitution.
Nash against Brogdon. And Nash gets double team.
Vas-y, shoot. Hein. Oh, l'enfoiré, toi.
Tatum on the wing. Takes a shot at the elbow, and it's good. 2 points. Tatum's got 4 points in the quarter.
Ouais, c'est pas grave, j'ai déjà fait mon 10.
Really good position with his footwork. Fundamentally sound. He's on fire right now.
Pass to Oladipo. Let's a floater go, and a great assist by Brogdon as that one goes in. Brogdon's got his 9th assist in the game now. Nash drawing the double team. It's Brown on the wing.
Et toi, plaisir. Ah, dommage. Des fois, souvent, il les mettait en fait.
And the layup's good off the glass. 14 points for Victor Oladipo.
Excellent concentration from Oladipo. Even when you get physical with him, he figures out a way to convert.
And Nash gets double team to the inside. And again, another assist.
That makes 15
eh oui.
Assists.
He's been one step ahead of the defense all game long. Oladipo, the pass to Turner. Brogdon against Nash. Back to Turner for the three. Rebound, Boston. Hayward's got rebound number 8 here tonight in the game. Tatum, that's for 2. Sabonis grabs the board. Sabonis has got rebound number 8 here tonight in the game. Brogdon with it. Poke loose, and the ball goes out of bounds.
Il a perdu le ballon. Grâce à qui?
Against Brogdon. And they double up Jay, the pass to Cantor.
Ah, c'est dommage. Mais bon, si on perd, si on a des bonnes occasions comme ça et on les met pas et que derrière on perd nos contre-attaques, enfin, eux ils gagnent leur contre-attaque. Ouais, ça va pas être. Mais non, tu me fais pas des passes à moi alors que je t'ai même pas demandé le ballon. Puis que tu vois très bien que je peux pas l'avoir la balle.
Sabonis trying to get open. Oladipo misses. Celtics leading by 22. Nash. And Nash gets double teamed. And Cantor wide open. He shoots. And good. As it just.
Ouais, je fais ça pour que mes potes puissent marquer, quoi.
Probably wasn't the shot they were looking for, but they'll take the bucket.
Passes it to Sabonis. And Tatum over to help. No one near Turner.
Oh, joli.
Traps in the tray. Gives him a double double in this one. 10 points.
Là-dessus,
and 14 rebounds. Nash against Brogdon. Nash drawing the double team and the turnover.
Putain, c'est même pas à toi que je voulais donner, c'était à l'autre.
Just carelessness there. I mean, you have got to have your head in the game.
Ça, c'est décevant pour un joueur comme moi de faire des passes qui n'aboutissent pas.
And out of bounds as the Pacers gain possession. And now look at Boston's upcoming schedule. On Thursday, they'll be matching up against Eric Bledsoe and the Milwaukee Bucks. And then on Friday, they'll take on John Wall and the Washington Wizards. Indiana's gotten off 4 three-pointers in the final quarter, and 2 of them have fallen. And the ball goes out of bounds. Last touch by Brogdon. Against Brogdon to the middle, Turner with the steal.
Ok, ça faut plus que je le tente. Alors. À moins que quand ils sont deux. Ben non, quand ils sont deux.
Pass to Sabonis. Here's Brogdon. Just 5 to shoot. Right block shot. Drained for 2 points. Brogdon's got 9 points now in the quarter.
Seems like he can't miss right now, guys. I mean, completely in the zone this quarter.
Nash kicks to Cantor. Moves back up. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot 2 at the free throw line. That's good from Cantor. And Cantor drops them both.
Ah oui, il faudrait peut-être que je donne la balle. Et après, je profite du trou.
Brogdon outside. No good with the triple.
You know, he's just chucking it up from distance this quarter. If you're going to do this, especially in the second half, you better make them.
The shot's good.
Yeah, the first half was one to deep six or forget. But in the second half, he's looked a lot better.
Ah merde! J'ai fait une faute.
Might force him to scale back the aggression from a defensive standpoint. He does not need, nor does the team need, number 5.
Tatum against Holland. 5 on the clock. It's blocked. Nash against Brogdon. Shea passes to Brown. It's good.
And, you know, really, guys, Brown is very talented at knocking down shots.
C'est cool, ça.
When getting hit.
Allez, monsieur l'arbitre, faut donner le ballon. Hein.
That free throw good from Brown. Indiana's gone 2-5 on three-point shots since the end of the third quarter. Brown against Oladipo. The pass to Sabonis. Holiday, no one around him. They can't stop the run with that one. Boston's gotten off to an 0-for-2 start from downtown here in the fourth quarter. Here's Hayward. Buries it down low. Hayward's got 20.
Well-rounded effort, and they show no signs of letting up.
Almost no holes in their performance tonight. They've been tremendous.
It's Oladipo on the wing. He's covered by Brown.
Ah. C'est bon, c'est revenu.
Back to Sabonis. Just five on the clock. Knocked away. Hand stolen by Jay.
Well, guys, this was never really a contest. Just a total obliteration, if you will. And you can safely say mission accomplished now for Boston.
You know, their big advantage was points in the paint.
And they found a way to pound the ball inside. And that was working all game long.
And this will push their record to 39 wins for tonight.
And so they're able to even up the season series at a game apiece with one left to play, exacting a little revenge and really saving face. They did not want to go down 2-0.
Most definitely. I mean, going down 2-0 would have made their third and final meeting of the season really difficult to win, but now they'll go into it with confidence and really liking their chances.
And joli.
We watched one guy all night long, guys, and look at the stats just confirms what a dominant game he had. What a night tonight it was for Jay.
Well, his defense was tremendous tonight.
Eh oui.
Really high level. He was a pest.
Retour en zone.
The opponents into a lot of turnovers.
54 seconds left in the fourth quarter.
Ah, purée!
Some solid defense from Johnson. Here's Sampson. He's covered by Murray. To stop the run. And it's off the back rim. No good. Here's Boston now. Mash outside.
Allez, au rebond, les gars.
But they'll get another chance. Williams kicks to Chain. It's deflected. Pushing it up. Here's Sumner. The Pacers keeping it going. A new 14-second clock.
And he did everything he could to make that shot as difficult as possible.
And you know what, guys? That will pump him up because he takes a ton of pride in what he does on defense.
And the shot is good.
And they came in determined to take this one. It's going to be a happy flight home.
Yep.
Woo! On a gagné.
The fans are already headed for the exit.
And so it's Boston easily grabbing this one. To come into an opponent's building and dominate the way they did tonight says, I think,
bam, nouveau badge. Des pépettes. Et interview. Oui, là j'ai appuyé, mais vous inquiétez pas.
Hey, Shaq, you guys stomped that team. Literally. It wasn't even close. When did you realize this game was yours to lose?
Qu'avez-vous ressenti que ce match ne pouvait plus vraiment vous échapper dès que j'ai vu le calendrier?
Hey man, I think the key for us was to never get comfortable having a lead. Treat the game as it was dead heat all four quarters, you know what I'm saying? Because as soon as we left that gas pedal against a team like that, boom, your advantage is gone. So we didn't feel like we had the game until it was obvious, too late, you know what I'm saying, for them to come back.
Man. Wow.
Bah oui. Ah! Il y en a un qui est blessé. Non? J'ai l'impression. Si on l'a vu, c'est que j'ai l'impression qu'il est blessé.
Just check the season averages, and you're up to 2 steals per game after tonight.
What? Word?
Yeah. How's that make you feel?
Qu'est-ce qu'il dit? Je suis à 2 interceptions de... Ça fait quoi d'avoir une moyenne de 10 interceptions par match?
Hey man, love picking pockets.
J'adore chipper le ballon.
Got it. Thanks, man.
No problem. Is that it?
That's it. Just missed this question earlier.
Shelby. Sorry, bro. Let me holler at you right quick.
Non! Je suis passé premier pour le rookie de l'année. Ah, là, c'est c'est ce match-là et le match d'avant, je crois. Non, le match d'avant encore. Où j'ai pas mal chippé le ballon. Et au niveau des interceptions ou de machin, ça m'a aidé. Rookie de l'année. Devant bah, tout le monde. Ça claque. Alors. Qu'est-ce qu'on fait? Bah, je le passe. Ouais, je vais faire ça. Puis après on va affronter les Bucks. Les Bucks, je sais plus si on, ils sont dans le haut du tableau. On verra ça. Allez. Je sais que c'est un peu chiant, c'est toujours la même chose, mais... Je vous en... Enfin, sur le live, c'est pas possible. Mais pour la rediff, je vous encourage à passer hein, ces moments-là. J'espère que vous le faites déjà. Sinon, ce serait bien d'avoir comme dans la folle histoire de l'espace. Spaceball. Où tu peux avoir la cassette avant même que le film y est sorti. Et tu as le moment où tu es au moment du truc. Ouais, les paniers s'enchaînent.
get to work. Here's what we're gonna do.
Ah, dommage. Je suis déçu. J'aurais mis celui d'avant et celui-là, c'était juste bon. Ah, dommage. Ah, mais c'est pas possible. Là, faut que je fasse que du green, quoi. Bon, bah tant pis. Pire ou pire? J'ai plus d'entraînement? Je regarde vite fait mon téléphone. J'ai pas de nouveaux trucs. Et puis là, bon. Non, j'ai pas fait une nouvelle couverture. Là, les gens ils disent que je qui me kiffe. Bon. Alors les Bucks sont premiers de l'Est. Ah oui d'accord, c'est les. Je vais me battre contre les premiers, d'accord. Bon bah allons-y. Battons-nous contre les premiers.
To assign a play to a player, scroll to the play you want to assign and then press the lob pass button. Then select the player you want to assign.
Ah, que se passe-t-il?
Everyone's attention for a minute. What's up, coach? I know a lot of you guys are looking forward to tonight's game.
Yeah.
I'm gonna see how you stack up against these guys, which you should. All right, just make sure you play within yourselves, okay?
Yeah.
Okay, know your role, right. Do your job. All right, play as a team, okay? I got no doubt in my mind that we can take on these guys, all right?
Yeah.
Start lock in. Win on three. One, two, three.
Win!
Hmm. Je sais pas, ils sont pas les premiers pour rien. The 2K Sports pregame
show. Hi everybody, thanks for joining us. Tonight it'll be the Boston Celtics squaring off against the Bucks in Milwaukee. Well, for Milwaukee, they're currently holding on to the best record.
Il compare les rookies.
Downtown Milwaukee is seen from the shore of Lake Michigan on a cloudless day. Welcome, sports fans. Thanks for joining us. It's the NBA on 2K Sports. Hi, everyone. This is Kevin Harlan, and joining us tonight, Greg Anthony and Hall of Famer Joris Burke. And reporting.
Allez. On est chez eux, faut les battre. Faut les battre pour les battre chez eux, quoi. Bon, j'y crois pas des masses, hein, mais comme on dit, l'espoir fait vivre. Suffit de bien défendre comme on fait d'habitude et puis voilà.
You seem to know and understand which teams are good on both sides of the basketball. Are they top five efficiency, offense and defense? And as you know, Kevin, if there's a player with a hot hand, that can really make a difference in round one.
Absolutely. And here's Nash. Against Indiana, he was really on his game. Here's Brown. Milwaukee with the rebound. Fresh from a win against the Nuggets.
And bottom line, they found ways to score. Credit the game plan going in.
Ah, ils ont une bonne contre-attaque.
And that's not an easy environment to play in. To score at the rate they did on the road says a lot about their intensity and focus.
And the foul on Eric Bledsoe. That's his first foul.
Ref's calling it close already as he picks up a quick early foul.
Nash kicks to Tatum. Six on the shot clock. Back to Nash. A three.
Oh, le green.
Well, you can tell there's a team first mentality with the young gun Jason Tatum working to find the open teammate. Nice.
Here's Antetokounmpo. It's hauled in by Brown.
You're not going to see that very often. Plenty of space, but he just, let's face it, he whiffs on that
one. Nash, that shot off, and Milwaukee the other way now. Bledsoe looking it over. Off on the layup.
They're one of four here to start, looking to get into a flow offensively.
Nice ball movement by Boston. Here's Jay.
Ah, j'ai fait n'importe quoi. Ah, j'ai fait une faute.
And the foul called on Shea. That is his first foul of the game. We're just about 2 minutes into the first quarter. Here's Antetokounmpo. That one falls. His second basket of the game. He's now 2 for 3.
You can't just stop when there's a pick set up. Gotta fight over it as a defender.
And Greg, you know exactly what that takes. It takes energy, it takes activity, it takes intensity.
Hayward on the wing, defended by Middleton, and the foul on Eric Bledsoe. That'll be his second foul of the game. George Hill's checked in for Eric Bledsoe. The drive by Jay. And oh boy, a lot of contact there, but he gets the call and will shoot two.
I'll tell you, off the dribble drive, Jay has proven he is unafraid.
First trip to the free throw line for him in this one.
And the Celtics last season mourning the passing of the great John Havlicek.
Si c'est ça, hein, on va aller au contact, on prendra des fautes et puis on marquera que avec des lancers francs.
Side. 13 feet away. DiVincenzo with the rebound. Milwaukee in the lead. Giannis outside. Pass to DiVincenzo. And the foul.
Oh non, mais pourquoi il fait ça, mon bonhomme? Et voilà, ils m'ont sorti.
Celtics leading by 6. On the floor for Boston. They've got Jay. Murray out there with Williams, and it's Wanamaker in at the shooting guard. Jay passes to Poirier. No one covers. Poirier's got the second quarter going with the first basket of the period for the Celtics. And there's the pass to Lopez. Outside Williams. Pass to Bledsoe. It's up a three. A shot. No good. And so Wanamaker will bring it up for the Celtics. They lead by eight. That's the biggest of the game. They defeated Indiana in their last game.
Yeah, facing that hostile crowd, they've just found a way to kind of tune out the noise and focus on the game.
Well, the best way to silence a crowd is with your offensive game. Those fans got quiet in a hurry when the buckets started raining down.
Ça va, ça prend des fans, ça prend des fans.
So let's check in with David Aldridge reporting from the sideline.
Thanks, Kevin. Che in the last game against the Pacers delivered quite a performance. He dropped in 29 points, and his passing was just incredible. He piled up an impressive number of assists. He put up great numbers and a terrific effort. It's not a game that anyone wanted to miss, and he'll be looking for a repeat performance tonight, Kevin.
Yeah, David, in stretches, he was absolutely dominant. Greg, he'd love to match that performance tonight.
This team needs his contributions. When he's right, he makes winning plays time and time again.
Well, when you're coming off a game like he had, you know the difference tonight. They're going to load up against him. They're going to try to take him out of his rhythm early.
Williams passes to Wanamaker. Launches a three. And Chris Middleton pulls it down.
Boy, he won't miss many from that spot. The defense gets lucky there.
No good. Shot missing. And the Celtics going the other way now. They traveled to Milwaukee last time they faced the Bucks, and they came away with a win.
A really close game between these two in that last matchup. It took a total team effort for them to get the win.
Yeah, I don't think they win without the productivity they got from their bench. That made the difference.
And it's sent back by Bledsoe.
The dogged defense from Mr. Bledsoe twice on the pipes.
Right side Matthews. Back to Middleton. And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting.
Putain, chaque fois que je veux faire un truc, je me fais bâcher.
If you were going to build a team around one player, who would that player be?
Well, I think because of his age and continued growth opportunity, I would probably say Giannis Antetokounmpo. He's playing at an MVP level. He's still got another decade where he's probably in the peak range of his playing capabilities. And the reality is Giannis still has so much growing to do. He's a force at the rim. He continues to build that three-point game. And Kev, once he gets that in-between game, he will be unguardable.
Can't argue with that at all.
I'll tell you, it has not been this guy's best night, but the teammates have been there to pick up the slack. Love it.
Passes it to Lopez. Makes it off the glass. Lopez has got eight.
Yeah, that's nice work in there on the inside. Lopez not having any issues converting that time.
Celtics passing it around. Wanamaker the pass to Tatum. Shot clock at six. And that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul.
GG, il y a la faute.
And you look at Jason Tatum able to play either forward position. Doris, do you think his future is at the three or at the four?
I think he is interchangeable at either position because his scoring can be devastating. For Jason Tatum, it's really a matter of making sure he continues to gain strength, continue to be a force and factor on the defensive end, and probably enhance his footwork around the rim a little bit.
They're finding lanes to the hoop now with consistency. Five buckets in a row from the paint.
Back to Jay. Rebound, Milwaukee.
Boy, the wheels.
Je pensais pas qu'elle passait en fait.
Shot from Bledsoe. Good, and the assist goes.
Celle-là non plus, je pensais pas qu'elle passait.
Middleton's got four assists in the game. Boston's gone 0-2 from deep here in the second. At the elbow, Williams. Back to Nash. Stolen by Bledsoe. Three on three. Knocks it loose. There's his third field goal, and now he's made half of his six shots.
Well, that's the athleticism of Mr. Eric Bledsoe. You love to see him be aggressive on the
ground. On gagné, je suis rentré sur le terrain et je fais perdre l'équipe.
On the wing, Williams. That one's off, still out of sync. The Bucks have gotten just over 50% of their shots to drop here in the second quarter. They're 5 for 9. Here's Bledsoe. Rebound by Williams. Williams has got his fifth rebound in this one. Tatum passes to Wanamaker. Pass to Williams. Jay outside. From past the arc.
Oh, le green est beau.
Nash has got 5 points now this quarter.
Le green est très beau.
Rise and fire with authority.
And it's Bledsoe off the drive. Here's Lopez. And there's the bucket. Staying with it on the offensive glass, getting it done. Lopez has got it all tied up now for the Bucks. Celtics have gone just 33% from the field in what's been a cold second quarter for them. Just 3 of 9. Outside Matthews. To the left side wing. Bledsoe can't get that one to drop.
Right now trying to get into a rhythm, but so far this quarter, boy, he is struggling to make anything go down. Well, not exactly one of those big, burly power forwards, right? He depends on his leaping ability more than those guys, and it serves them just fine, Kev.
Now a timeout called by Milwaukee. As the teams head into this timeout, a chance for the coaches now to map out some plays for the next few minutes and a chance for the players to rehydrate.
La minute des t-shirts.
If they want to make sure they don't wear down later in the game.
Absolutely. Over the course of a game, you have to stay hydrated.
A different look for Milwaukee. Lopez, he's checked in for Lopez. Antetokounmpo comes in for Williams. And it's Hill in for Matthews. And then for Boston. Innis Kanter's checked in for Williams, and it's Green in for Brad Wanamaker. Nash against Bledsoe. There's the pass to Kanter. Hayward looking over the floor. Nash can't get it to go.
And you know, you can't impact a shot that close any better than he did on that possession.
Boy, joli. He blocks it or simply alters it, the result is pretty.
Ah non, mais pourquoi tu me fais la passe?
Antetokounmpo with the ball. Now guarded by Tatum. Antetokounmpo can't get it to go. Boston's gone 1 of 3 from way outside since the start of the second quarter. Down low. Here's Hayward. And that one clearly a foul. Gets the whistle and two shots coming up. That's on Brooklyn.
Joli. Oh non, mais non, ne foire pas.
In the corner, Tatum with it. Let's the three fly, drills it from outside. Tatum's got 11 points. And Doris, you talk about when Gordon Hayward is playing his best. What makes him, in your mind, so special?
Well, when he's right physically, he can be a go-to offensive weapon, Kevin. This guy is the true definition of triple threat, right? He can pick you apart with his passing, with his shooting, and also off the dribble drive. Boy, when he's right, he is tough to stop.
Got a piece of oh non, putain, je me suis fait prendre le ballon.
Contact on the shot, and now a
et je fais une faute, putain.
George Hill has exceptionally quick hands. He does such a good job coming up with steals.
Well, George Hill, the veteran guard, doesn't produce at the volume he once did. Still, he brings a lot of value to a team.
It has been nip and tuck through the first half.
Exactly, guys. The way it's seesawed back and forth.
My goodness.
About putting some extra on it. That dunk was way over the top.
Close game or not, he's gonna finish firm when he gets the space. Tatum passes to Chang, fires high post, and he wills that one in, sinking right through off the back iron.
Well, there's more to basketball than threes and lay-ins. Che doing work in the mid-range there.
Here's Antetokounmpo. That's tipped.
wonder what the score would be if they weren't controlling the backboard.
Shea dishes to Cantor. Lopez with the block.
Lopez needs to hold down the court on defense. An incredible wingspan to get that one.
And he'll shoot free throws here. Clearly fouled on that shot that time.
Ah là 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 là, c'est pas possible.
There's the call. Foul on Boston. For Milwaukee, they have knocked down 8 of 9 free throw attempts. I'd say those numbers read pretty well.
And 75% on the season as a unit from the free throw line.
Marcus Smart checked in for Kemba Walker. Here's Nash. Good, and Smart gets the assist. Shea's got 9 points in the quarter.
Well, just tremendous concentration. Shea with a total focus on finishing the play.
Nash against Hill. Trying to get open is Lopez. They grab their own miss.
Boy, he did everything right till he got to the rim. He needs to finish that.
Smart misses.
Oh, that's a golden opportunity to finish on the break, and he blows it.
It was right there for him. He'd love to have that one back. That was embarrassing.
And it's been an exciting game. Both teams really fighting this one out.
Nash, the pass to Cantor. Back to Jay. Lopez with the steal.
Non, j'étais trop. Comment on appelle ça?
DiVincenzo can't hit it. There's Nash with the three. No good on the last.
Dommage. Je l'aurais griné celui-là, il nous aurait fait plaisir.
Kevin, thanks. Well, Jay, your name is right in the middle of all this rookie of the year talk. So, does that get you going in any way?
Est-ce que le titre de rookie de l'année vous motive? Oui, ça me motive. Ma priorité est d'aider mon équipe à gagner.
Hey, look, I don't play for the awards. It's cool to have my name in contention. But continue to prove my game and help my team find its way. That's my priority. That said, I admit that does feel nice to have some recognition.
Well, you have earned that.
Thank you, David, and we'll be right back after halftime to start the third quarter. See you in just a bit.
Ah oui, non mais voilà, complètement. Complètement. Je suis d'accord que le titre de rookie de l'année, c'est cool. Mais moi, c'est pas ça qui me motive. Moi, c'est... on joue match par match, on essaye de les gagner. Voilà quoi, c'est... Avant tout, c'est l'équipe. Déjà, mon but, c'est le...
Thing has been his incredible consistency. This guy is a great player who always brings a ton of energy. What a great half.
Well, we've got a moment. Let's set the floor. Brought to you by Gatorade, all fueled up for the second half.
Mon but, c'est le...
Middleton and Giannis are the forward tandem. And it's Brook Lopez.
Oh non, il le met.
Putain.
Mon but, c'est les playoffs.
To Brown. Back to Nash.
Oh.
Inside, Cantor, and Cantor throws it down.
Those plays can make a difference in a game like this.
Well, you know it's going to fire up, Greg, everybody on that bench.
Well, credit him for going for it, not settling, saying, I'm going to attack.
Here's Middleton, and there are the Bucks with another bucket.
Après oui, après l'équipe, ouais, donc après la récompense personnelle, ouais, ça fait plaisir quand même, mais bon. Putain, les mecs sont toujours là pour me bâcher, quoi. Même Tatum, il se fait bâche. Qu'est-ce que tu veux qu'on fasse?
And you know, for Boston, where they are living the dream, continuing this improbable journey, proving throughout the year that they're the real deal. Oh, taking it to the rack with power, hammering down the two-hand slam.
Non, ça passe pas en fait. Oh là là, mais c'est pas possible. C'est pas possible.
What I like here, even with the big lead, they continue to execute their offense.
And that to me, Greg, is a sign of excellent coaching. There's an attention to detail. There is valuing of every possession.
Brown, good.
Well, this is what they love seeing from Jaylen Brown, the aggressiveness down near the cup. This guy's attitude, tremendous.
Bucks leading by 8. Antetokounmpo looking it over. From the arc. And again, Milwaukee with the triple.
Il les met comme ça, non mais...
Chance shot. He takes it up and lays it in. Cantor's got 6 points.
Really surprising to see the huge edge they have in rebounds given what the scoreboard says.
Nash against Bledsoe. This is it to Antetokounmpo. Two free throws coming.
Ouais, mais je suis en train de couvrir. Si vous faites des fautes derrière les mecs, ça sert à rien. Autant les laisser shooter, quoi.
To watch or cover or report on.
All right, Kevin, you know I can't possibly name one, so I'm going to just throw several names out there. LeBron James has overcome so many challenges as a young person even before his NBA career. So his story is absolutely incredible and inspirational. How about Kevin Durant, one of the greatest scorers in the history of the NBA?
Ouais.
Or Damian Lillard, who has proven so loyal to his fan base and organization.
Allez les filles, on lance.
Marvin Williams is checked in for the Bucks. Matthews comes in for Dante DiVincenzo. Then for the Celtics, Williams comes in for Enes Kanter. And Brad Wanamaker subbed in for Tatum. Williams kicks to Hayward. Nash outside. Rebound by Williams. And so Antetokounmpo will bring it up for the Milwaukee Bucks. Their defense has only allowed 6 points in the second half. Shots good by Bledsoe.
And of the last 6 baskets, 5 have come on the interior. This is just smash mouth physical basketball, guys.
Nash with it. 14 points for him. Wanamaker looking over the floor. Shot, so he'll get a chance at the line. Ashley Matthews picks one up.
Just such a physical player. Williams has no off switch, which is how he gets these calls.
And Williams drops them both. And so it's Milwaukee with it. Giannis left side. Matthews finds Giannis. A 3, Bledsoe, and a great assist by Antetokounmpo.
C'est ma faute, j'ai pas couvert, bordel. Pourquoi je veux défendre dedans alors qu'on était au moins 3 ou je sais pas combien.
I'll tell you, this guy is doing absolutely everything he can to get himself going, but the team is struggling because he's struggling.
And they're scoring much more efficiently here in the second half, and they've gotten that field goal percentage above 50.
On its way from Hayward for 2, and he knocks down the jumper. Bucks leading by 15. Bledsoe kicks to Antetokounmpo. And the dunk by Giannis.
Yeah, I mean, the ball handling and body control for a guy that's Giannis's height, it's really impressive.
Boston's getting blank from three-point land so far in the third. Still 0 for 3. Pass to Williams. Ah! back to Nash. Great pass to set up the lay-in. Nash has got 16 points.
That's just wanting it more. The book on Che used to be he was soft. That book was wrong.
Adetokunbo kicks to Matthews. And the pass to Bledsoe. Middleton outside. From outside, off the mark.
And the great shooters know when they've got enough opening to go for the three. I didn't think it was a bad choice on that possession.
I'll tell you, it feels all night.
En même temps, si on loupe tous nos shoots, et eux, ils réussissent tous, les probabilités, forcément...
Antetokounmpo passes to Bledsoe. Count it. Bledsoe's got 9 points now.
Voilà, hein. Les mecs, dès qu'ils ont le ballon, ils shootent et ils marquent. Nous, dès qu'on a le ballon, on shoot, on marque pas. Donc forcément, au bout d'un moment...
He admitted his most trying in the 12 years as a coach. Boy, he is looking to get them back on track.
Hill, he's checked in for Milwaukee. Green, he's checked in for the Celtics.
Ah, mais je suis obligé de faire des shoots à 3 points. Faut que je rattrape mon retard.
Walker against Bledsoe.
And Hill, par contre, il m'avait bien bloqué là.
Bledsoe's got 5 assists tonight.
Si on fait pas de shoot à 3 points,
Hill against Nash. He dishes it to Walker. And the rejection by
Oh là là. Voilà pourquoi je veux faire des shoots à 3 points. Chaque fois qu'on voit sous l'anneau. On se fait bâcher.
From deep, Che knocks down the three ball. Nash has got 19 points.
Watch out. Now that he's got his first three of the half, there might be more in store.
Bounce pass on Adetokunbo. Bledsoe against Hayward.
Oh, joli.
Stolen by Hayward. Yep. One goes. Hayward's got 4 this quarter.
That's what you call taking care.
Ah, ça a l'air d'aller mieux. Je crois que c'était lui qui avait un problème à son pied au dernier match.
Hayward against Williams, outside Hill. Fires for 3. It's good.
Oh là là.
16 points for him.
Les mecs font des shoots à 3 points, ça rentre.
Tipped away. It's off his foot, and the ref saying he kicked it. Boston making a switch here. Cantor
stepped in. Yeah, like.
Nash against Hill. On the wing, Green. They get the rebound.
I'll tell you, he's been much better in the second half. He's taking smarter shots. He's looking more comfortable. And guess what? He's in a groove.
And so it's Bledsoe with it, bringing it up for the Bucks. Let's it go from 14, and Cantor pulls it down. Cantor's got 10 rebounds here tonight.
Ah, excuse-moi. D'habitude, il vient pas, donc j'avais pas vu, mais.
Hill passes to Matthews. Nash against Bledsoe. Outside Williams. He can't get that one. Now Boston takes it the other way. Nash drives in. Excellent D there from Williams.
And his defense is so valuable. Not many can bother that.
Je pensais pas que c'était moi qui allais foirer.
Boy, you see the effort. You see the range. This guy prides himself in his ability to shut you down.
And the slam dunk by Antetokounmpo.
The pass there floated it up to the precise spot it needed to be.
And no messing around on the finish. He powers it through. Pass to Walker.
Ouais, ça pue quand même, hein.
Kicks it it out to Chang. Fires the three. Excellent D there from Hill. Milwaukee leading by 17. There's Bledsoe.
Non, c'est pas possible, je le bloque du fond. Je me dis que les mecs, voilà, déjà il fait une passe de ouf. Et en plus, il marque juste. Non, mais. C'est peut-être une meilleure passe qu'il aurait eu.
Bledsoe outside. Clock at four. Here's Antetokounmpo. A rebound by the Celtics. Cantor's got rebound number 12 now. Tenacity on the glass. Hayward passes to Walker.
Ah, joli.
The basket good off the assist from Hayward.
Joli le 3 points.
12 points for Walker.
I'll tell you what a night. He has been efficient. He's been strong. Unfortunately, they're still fighting an uphill battle.
They get it back. Out of bounds. Boston takes possession. There's 18 seconds left to play in the third. Passes to Cantor. Tatum on the wing. This one for three.
Oh, joli.
Parries the long range jumper.
Joli le green.
14 points for the game.
Jason Tatum is the complete package on the offensive end. He can drive it, he can get to the mid-range, and now the three-point shot.
I mean, he's just been brilliant today, guys, and it was the same exact story last time out.
Giannis Antetokounmpo, he's...
Ouais, mais si on met un 3 points et derrière, ils nous remettent un 2 points...
State Farm assist of the game.
Yeah, an easy choice tonight. Look at the precision on this pass. Put it on a
platform.
And when you're the beneficiary of a pass that good, you better deliver. And he did just that.
And one quarter to go in a game that to this point has not been an evenly fought contest. And a look at the five for the Celtics to start the fourth quarter. Tatum and Cantor together down low. Kemba Walker is out there with Nash, and it's Smart in at the small forward. And he gets the whistle. Two free throws coming up. Doris, you've accomplished so much in your award-winning career. What was your first experience in broadcasting?
Kevin, my first experience was I left coaching, and they put Providence College women's basketball on radio. That was the first ever game I got to call. It was so cool. Tell me yours. What was the very first? Did you study this? How did you get into broadcasting?
I did. Our high school had a radio station, and the first basketball broadcast was underneath the bleachers, looking through popcorn boxes and legs of the people who were standing in the bleachers so that I could see the court from the baseline.
Amazing.
Because that's where the telephone cables were to plug in our equipment. And
wow.
I was 16 years old.
Incredible.
Remembered very well.
Incredible.
Very well. Antetokounmpo against Tatum. He lobs up the alley-oop pass, takes the alley-oop pass and dunks it down.
Non, mais les mecs, c'est qui? C'est Harlem Globetrotters ou quoi?
Antetokounmpo, a good decision maker, improves his passing each and every year.
Cantor, the pass to Che. And they double up Che. Lopez with the block, and he's able to get it back. He was all
ouais, joli.
They've been the better rebounding team by a healthy margin, but it hasn't been enough.
Nash against Hill. First minute and a half of basketball played here in the fourth quarter. Giannis, no good.
Boy, surprised he missed that. The defense just good enough to prevent that bucket.
Here's Tatum, and slam dunk by Tatum.
And they are very comfortable running their offense through Walker. And you can see why. Drops a sick dime right there. That pass was right on the money.
Alors là, je m'en fous pour ce match de faire mon quota. Mon double-double, machin. Ce qui compte, c'est qu'on gagne.
The tendency can
be to
really rush or push the game. And they need to avoid that.
And there's the bucket from Tatum.
One thing Jason Tatum has showed us is he can make contested shots in the NBA. Think about that guy, so young, yet so unshakable.
Here's DiVincenzo.
Si on peut mettre plus de paniqueux. Genre si par exemple, je sais pas, on en met 2, voire 3, et qu'eux ils en mettent qu'un. Voilà, là il y a de la faute. Mêlé, hein, Jason.
Milwaukee making a switch here. Middleton's checked in. Jaylen Brown's checked in for Boston. Middleton can't get it to go.
I'll tell you, even though he's not playing his best basketball, the team has played well and picked it up. I love it.
Nice shot by Smart.
Ah, j'aurais pu faire un alley-oop avec lui. Je sais qu'il en est capable.
If that run had come any later, it would have been KD bar the door.
Showing so much passion and determination here at the end. They're close to the lead, but still have plenty of work left to do.
And it goes out of bounds. Last touch by Antetokounmpo. Here's Boston now. They're on a 12-4 run. Nash right side. Nash drawing the double team. Brown wide open. He fires.
Désolé, dommage qu'il soit pas dehors. Un petit 3 points, ça aurait fait plaisir. Oh putain, les mecs ils font des alley-oops quoi. C'est quoi son jeu, il est basé sur le alley-oop ou quoi?
Shaves got 23.
And it just seems that every pass they make is leading to a score. Just great ball movement.
Now here's Lopez. Shoots the three. It's hauled in by Jay.
Well, you can see why the defense dared him to shoot it. That's not really his spot.
Tatum shot.
Oh putain.
And so Giannis will bring it up for Milwaukee. Leading by 5. Middleton outside. Milwaukee getting another chance here.
Eh putain, il récupère. Les gars, les rebonds chez nous, c'est à nous. C'est une règle.
No doubt on the scoreboard, in the body language of the players, you can tell which team is in complete command.
Yes, petite interception là.
On Friday, they'll go up against Bradley Beal and the Washington Wizards. Then on Sunday, they'll begin a road trip starting in Chicago.
C'est quoi, c'est notre dernier match de février celui-là?
And looking at this stretch for them, I think they should have no problem dispatching most of their opponents if they can avoid that pitfall of playing down to the level of the competition. But that's easier said than done.
Bien joué.
Now to just three on the bucket from Cantor.
Just impressed with the teamwork out there, setting the table for one another.
Antetokounmpo kicks to Lopez. Fires the three. Rebounded by Smart. Celtics have gone 8 of 10 from the field here in the fourth quarter. Really getting it done. And it's Brown missing.
C'est dommage.
Easy to stop this guy at the rim, but that is a beautiful contest right.
Oh non.
Offensive rebound. Antetokounmpo. And the jump by Giannis.
Il est toujours chez nous, hein. À nous prendre nos rebonds.
And you know what, Greg? Once he gets his hands on it, he's not even thinking about kicking it out.
No reason to do so there. He was going to leave, no doubt.
And with that, the Bucks lead is cut down now to just 3 on the basket from Nash.
Has he risen to the challenge down the stretch or what? 3 or 4 here in the fourth.
A floater. The kick out to Hill. Here's Giannis.
Il y arrive, hein, mais c'est pas possible.
Giannis has got 32 points in the game.
Well, you love his effort level, right? Particularly when it's winning time. He is going for the finish.
Brown the pass to Tatum. Puts it up from 17. Again, the Celtics good for 2.
Bucks leading by three. Here's DiVincenzo. Six to shoot. And the slam dunk by Antetokounmpo.
Mais mine de rien, on a pas mal remonté.
Celtics need to get a shot off. Unloads from 13. The shot, no good. Bucks have gone 7 to 16 from the field here in the fourth. That's about 43%. Snatched up. Antetokounmpo. Got it. Good job.
Putain.
Now it's a 7-point Bucks lead.
It just seems like the more he touches it, the more the lead grows.
Oh non.
No good. Great move on his way to the bucket there.
Dessus les gars, dessus, faut pas qu'ils ont la contre-attaque. Voilà.
Outside Hill. There's the triple. And it's out of bounds to the Bucks as Milwaukee retains possession.
Ah, bien joué quand même, bien joué quand même.
Bledsoe's checked in. Celtics also with a sub. Gordon Hayward's checked in for Smart.
Il est tout seul en dessous, il est tout seul en dessous.
Scooped up. Pass to DiVincenzo. And Bledsoe has it in the corner.
Putain, je le... C'est de ma faute, c'est de ma faute, c'était le mien, c'était mon bonhomme.
Eric Bledsoe has length, he's got explosiveness and he's got a knack for scoring. Bledsoe against Nash. Tatum passes to Che. Lopez with the block.
Putain, je me prends toujours des bâches, ça me saoule.
On the shot clock.
Shoot.
Tatum against Antetokounmpo. A nice shot by Tatum.
I'll tell you, despite this guy's strong play in this period, they're still behind. Someone else has got to step up.
And stolen by Che.
Mais c'est pas possible.
Bledsoe outside. Shoots from the corner. And that
oh was putain. Putain, on était en train de revenir, on se prend une volée.
Hayward against Middleton. Hayward kicks to Che. No good on the three.
You've got to find a way to get yourself going in some other way because hoisting from three is not the answer.
Bah vas-y, laissez-le passer. Ah non, si ouais, c'est ça. J'ai cru qu'il l'avait arrêté, mais non. Mais putain, les gars. Ah oui, je vais faire que des shoots à 3 points, moi, je suis obligé. Ah mais on va se prendre que des contre-attaques, ça m'énerve. Je... Bon allez, j'accepte, on a perdu le match. Tant pis. Ouais, vu l'heure, ce sera mon dernier match. Parce qu'après c'est l'entraînement jusqu'à 7h. Donc... Et après je lui fais la faute. C'est bon ça.
Bledsoe against Nash. Now the pass to Cantor. Here's Tatum. Brown dishes to Tatum. Here's Cantor. The kick out to Tatum. They shoot again. Good. He hits the jump shot. Tatum's got 15 points here in the second half.
You have to be effective from anywhere on the floor if you're going to be elite. Jason Tatum, the in-between game, that's on point two, fellas.
Pass to DiVincenzo. Now Lopez. He's covered by Cantor. Five to shoot. Passes it to DiVincenzo. Antetokounmpo trying to break loose. Offensive rebound.
Ça m'énerve, putain, le mec, ils ont tous les rebonds. Vous êtes nuls les gars, vous n'êtes pas censés prendre les rebonds chez vous. Que tu prends pas les rebonds dans l'équipe adverse. Je veux bien. Je dis d'accord. Mais que tu te fais prendre tous tes rebonds chez toi, non. 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 On regarde pas, hein. Ah, ça c'est beau ça. Je voudrais en voir plus. Mais chez nous en fait. Ouais, ma faute. J'ai mal défendu. Ah putain. Ouais, je sais, je suis n'importe quoi, mais bon. C'est la fin du match, je craque. J'ai déjà accepté la défaite. Franchement, quand on était revenu, j'aurais dû faire des fautes.
Et c'est fini. J'ai eu un nouveau badge. B+, 27 points. Dean, nous sommes vraiment très heureux du travail que tu as accompli en tant que franchise player de cette équipe. Tu as été à la hauteur et tu as su prouver que tu étais prêt à endosser plus de responsabilités. C'est pourquoi nous aimerons que tu prennes part aux décisions relatives à l'effectif. Et aux rotations, n'hésite pas. Non, je touche pas à ça, moi. Eh, je veux pas devenir coach, les gars. Je suis joueur, c'est tout. Je sais pas, peut-être l'explosivité des premiers pas Après une triple menace ou un chase-up. Non, on va augmenter mes collègues. Ah, l'entraînement est mort. Bah, c'est pas grave, je le referai plus tard. 446 à 500, ouais. Ouais, 38. Bon, sur ce, merci à tous d'avoir regardé cet épisode. Normalement, on en... Ah non, putain, on était déjà au mois de mars. On a bientôt fini. Il nous reste 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. 17 matchs. Ouais. Ouais. Bon, on va s'arrêter là. J'espère que vous avez apprécié. Les premiers matchs, j'ai bien kiffé parce que même si à un moment donné ça avait été dur le deuxième match. On s'en est bien sorti et voilà. Celui-là était plus dur et j'ai commencé à faire des erreurs. En fait, j'ai perdu le rythme. Et une fois que je me suis perdu, bah, c'était fini. Et voilà, c'est tout. Donc j'espère que ça vous a plu. On se revoit très bientôt pour un nouvel épisode. Prenez soin de vous. À ciao.